already know what's poppin'.
Should love him.
Everybody should love Juan. Well, welcome to another episode of the Death Rush Show. I am your motherfucking host, the pie guy, Juan. Well, you know, some of my friends really, really close ones, they call me. Mark.
You really telling people your gub?
Man,
you ain't been saying your gub.
It's a podcast, Birdie Man. You never, if you listen, you never know what I might say.
Speaking of that,
what's so happening?
I was traveling down an old school podcast rabbit hole.
Da-na-na-na-na-na.
And I was listening to old episodes of Hostially Awkward.
Oh my God.
And I realized we literally threw away our whole spiel that we used to do in the beginning.
Damn, what did we used to do in the beginning?
I don't remember how it started. It was like the habitual lie stepper, the voice of the voiceless.
Oh,
and I
no.
can't remember the name. It was like, Doug, why did we stop saying that?
Oh, man. You want to know where that shit came from? It's because I feel like everything we do, like, it always has a callback to something. We started doing that shit because we was what? Because it came from wrestling. And remember when Paul Heyman would have that whole spiel where he would introduce CM Punk?
Yo, you right.
He was like the voice of the voiceless, and then the way Mimi be on like Facebook and Twitter, getting all these hoes in a frenzy agreeing with her. That's where it came from.
We need to bring it back. Everything after the conversation we had about tonight's conversation, is that what's called?
Yeah, that's,
it made sense. So I was like, no, we need to go back to that. Yeah. Matter of fact, have the backyard again do it.
Yeah, that's crazy. They could do the intro.
The whole.
So, we are here with a guest today. Would you like to introduce yourself to my people?
Hello, hello, hello. I am Diamond, better known as Dito.
Sound like she said that. And she is Dito.
Hey, if you need
keep the pound.
8-ball to get started, bro, holla at Dito.
Holla at Dito. She going to put you on.
Yeah.
You got to go to the back door. Right. Second door. One. Right. Knock 3 times.
On the G. She got the knockdown. What do you do in your free time, young lady? Man, she had the knockdown back. You hear that knock? You already know what's going on.
Are there 2B movies though?
You said what?
She said she watched 2B movies.
I got some 2B movies up in there. I got some 2B movies up in there.
What is your... Go ahead.
2B got these in a chokehold.
Cause, bro, okay, I was talking to Bianca from Purpose Over Pain podcast before they got started, and I was like, Tubi is the new variation of black exploitation movies from back in the days. So if you ever had the opportunity to go back and watch all these terrible ass black movies,
yes,
they were all literally people in their neighborhoods, in their cities, just making movies about it. Like, bro, there's an old black exploitation movie where a barrel of cotton, I'm talking raw, unprocessed cotton, fell off the back of the truck.
That's wild.
And because this big ass bale of cotton is so fucking important, because that's like literally uncut money at that point, you could sell that for millions, the whole hood was going crazy over trying to find this fucking cotton. Literally, the whole movie.
Just
niggas going crazy over it.
And this is on Tubi?
No, this is an old-ass black exploitation movie. But now, fast forward to Tubi. Tubi is nothing but a bunch of people in Detroit got together and said, let's make hood movies.
I'm not finna let you call Tubi the new...
It is.
Black exploitation. Dog. Okay. Shut up, dog. Come
have
on,
you
man.
Okay.
We only been on air for like 5 minutes and you already wilding the fuck out, dog. What is one?
Have you ever watched a Tubi movie? An actual Tubi original?
I have not sat through an entire Tubi movie, but I've seen bits and pieces.
That's part of the problem right there. You gotta go down this rabbit hole, my guy.
Gee, I don't know if I really
and
want
every
to.
Every Tubi movie is gonna have the basic 5 points in their plot. One, somebody's a drug dealer, okay? There is some sense of drugs, or drug selling, or drug paraphernalia, or drug usage in a Tubi movie. It's just damn near a requirement.
Like, you can't get away from it.
Can't get away from it. Like, literally a staple in the hood.
Gotcha.
Okay? Number two, somebody got enormous ass. There's always ass in these movies.
Yes.
Okay?
Because
the ass, and whether it's real, whether it's a BBL, whether it's a nice shaped BBL, yes, we did it right, there's ass in this movie.
I feel
okay? Number three.
Number three.
Most plot points have betrayal in it. girlfriends, on boyfriends, best friends, guys, drug dealers. On, there's some form of betrayal in every single movie.
Yes.
Okay. There's always a plot in these movies that results in a lesson that has to be learned at the end of the movie. Because if I didn't learn nothing from this movie, it's not good. Okay. And then finally, it's niggas from your neighborhood. You are not going to find, you are not going to find Lawrence Fishburne in a Tubi movie.
No.
You're not.
But you know who you keep seeing? Marcus Houston.
Is he broke?
I don't know.
See, when you start, like, when you got a little bit of money and then you start doing Tubi movies, I'm questioning
it. I don't always think that's the case, because old boy who played, was it Jamal Woodard?
Yeah.
Biggie?
Gravy? Or
yeah, Gravy.
Yeah, because he's been in a he lot does of them, Tubi, but I feel like that's...
He does it on purpose.
He but got a network, though.
Yeah, he works
in
with
Detroit
here.
And everything.
And he got
so,
people here. Yeah, he works with Swift Motion here.
He has found his niche in life.
How do we know Marcus Houston?
Nah, didn't find Marcus his niche? Houston can sing, bro.
Marcus Houston and, came from Somebody Help Me.
Who is coming to a Marcus Houston concert?
Save the last
old bitches who love Immature.
You got so served? You telling me that if, hear me out now.
Okay.
Tevin Campbell
right.
doing a concert down the street.
Okay.
Then you hear Marcus Houston is at the Riverside. Where do you think bitches are going? Tevin
or
Marcus?
What's the age demo?
They're gonna go to Tevin. I don't know why, but they gonna go to Tevin.
What's the age demo though?
You like that R&B?
You just said old.
How many songs do Tevin Campbell really got?
He got at least six albums.
Six albums. How many? Six albums. And how many songs do niggas play from this nigga?
All you gotta play is five.
But they only play two.
No, they play five.
They play Can We Talk and I'm Ready.
And then you got the ooh ah song.
I never hear it.
What's the ooh ah?
My point exactly. You be
young,
outside?
You young though.
You be outside though?
You young.
You be do you be
you
outside?
You young.
Do you be in the bar?
Unless you hang you out.
Be
out
if you be outside,
you don't know.
If you be outside,
I work at an older bar.
But you didn't been to an R&B night a few times in your life, right?
So how I go?
In the 90s mix, when you get to Tevin Campbell.
You 90 mix. Yeah, you go
when you hit Tevin Campbell in the 90s mix, you gonna get Can We Talk?
My fault is not ish.
That you shush, nigga.
It shush is always in my heart. Tell me what you want me to do. Round and round. Goodbye. He got enough song that the old bitches is gonna throw their drawers on stage.
Again, two songs.
The young bitches like Can We Talk?
Can We Talk and I'm Ready?
I don't know where.
They're not playing shit else from this bum ass nigga.
But it's not
now. Marcus Houston, I ain't gonna lie. I'm gonna go to that river.
See
him though, because he got some look, super gems,
but super slaps.
But look at the age difference of what we just said. Tevin Campbell
facts.
Initially came out like what 90s, 2000s, because his greatest hits dropped in 2001. Okay, so that means that most of the people who go into Tevin. Only remember Marcus Houston as a little kid in House Party 3. And Roger. That's it.
Thanks.
They may not even remember the nigga made a song about giving
it up, Tom. Don't nobody listen to Tevin Campbell.
No, nobody that you kick it with.
No, ain't nobody listening.
Nigga, I guarantee you, Garfield Days right now done played at least.
They done played I'm Ready and Can We Talk.
And they definitely.
They're not playing shit else from this nigga.
They play round and round.
They're not playing shit. You got it, bro. Next topic. They're not playing shit.
You tell you why I know they play.
Boo, get this nigga out of here.
They played it during the same time. They probably got done playing a couple of Prince songs because Tevin Campbell basically got introduced in the Prince movie.
Get this nigga out of here.
Fuck you.
Boo.
You just mad because
case closed.
You like Donnell Jones.
So what? Case closed.
He got some hits actually.
Oh, no, we're not saying he's bad. He's a bad dude. He's a horrible person.
He's a great guy.
He's a horrible person.
He's a great guy. That was a great song.
That's a horrible song.
Hey, they say when you love someone, you just don't treat them bad.
Okay.
How I feel so sad. Now that I want to leave. She's crying her heart to me. Now, how could you let this be? But I just need time to see I want to be.
So
this is bars.
So he has
how is this
great,
not bars?
He has a great woman. He has a woman that loves and wants to give him the world. And is willing to put up with his bullshit, but you say, baby, I can't be with you because I can't stop putting my dick in other bitches.
Right, because we've been together since our teenage years.
Why are we
bro?
Acting like that's not the reality right now?
That is why it's a horrible song.
But you know how old it is?
That's what make it worse.
But I'm saying, bro, we've been together.
Oh, putting us on what our daddy and them was doing.
Right. Holes are gonna be
and
holes,
every
so
and the people we
them.
With we've ain't been do shit but watch their daddy.
Right.
The same shit
we've
he's
been,
singing
they've
about.
Been together since they teenage years. Facts. And he really just needed to see what was in the world.
That's true, though. I could see that part, too. It's
right. Like, now, what? Now. See, now.
here's
the caveat to Donnell Jones.
But
see, it wasn't what he said.
It's what he did.
It's what he did. How do you tell your bitch, like, hey, I want to fuck up the bitches, and I want you to be okay with it.
At least he told the truth.
And then when you see your bitch finna fuck another nigga, you are not okay with that. You all at the window in a leather fucking coat in the middle of the summer crying and shit. What are you doing, Donnell Jones?
The love that we share is real.
All right, they died about a bit. In time, your heart will heal.
You'll be okay.
He wasn't okay.
Like, but at least
but
I told
at
you.
At the end of the day, I want both of y'all to have this same energy for the kickback on the 29th. Because when we do the lyrical battle, I expect you niggas.
I'm coming with the heat.
To know lyrics.
I'm coming with the
heat. I know songs.
Even if I got to look it up.
Niggas, y'all sat here and played the game with me while I was high and I knew every fucking thing.
I'm just saying. I'm just letting people know who are listening.
See, my friends think that because I do drugs, that I'm fucking stupid. And I don't understand that, why they think that.
No.
Will I say I'm a little tape delayed? I won't lie on that. Like, is it like 3 seconds later?
Yeah.
Cool. But I'm not dumb.
We didn't say you were dumb.
And I feel
Juan.
Like they be treating me like the fucking sped in the back of the classroom. I don't get it. It's really fucking wild.
It's because sometimes, Juan, if we're not having a direct conversation with you, you will say whatever the fuck is in space.
That's true.
And that is where we
be liking
now,
it.
Have the problem.
Before we hit why we are here.
Well,
I know. I know. I'm very much on here with guests. I was telling my uncle that we had like, me and you had a sneaker beef and you didn't even know it.
What's our sneaker beef?
So this is what I told my uncle. Because like, he like when he know I'm about to pod, if I don't got no slides on, he'll be like, you know what shoes you gonna wear. So I've been feeling like it's like I'm gonna put some Air Max on today. So I sent him a picture. He was like, I thought you would have worn these. I was like, it's like, nah, man. I think Tom think I'm some type of bitch ass nigga. He was like, you know. So I'm explaining to him why I feel this way. I was like, see, Tone, when I do put my shoes on, Tone only see me wear some Jordans. I feel like because Tone from that era where Air Max was cracking, Tone think I ain't got no heat in my closet with some Air Max.
Oh, that's what you think.
So I sent the picture to Hunk. I was like, I'm going to wear some 95s all weekend because Tone think I ain't got no motherfucking Air Max. He think I was the type of bitch ass nigga.
Look, fam. You can wear 95s all you want to, but until you step into the world of the vapes, don't talk to me.
I hate that big ass air bubble.
Until you wear that big ass air bubble,
I bet it's comfortable though.
You did a motherfucking.
But it looks so stupid.
When I have heel spurs, I don't put on my Skechers. I put on my vapes.
I can't.
Like walking on clouds, my nigga.
That big ass air bubble annoys me.
It do squeak a little from time to time.
It do squeak a little.
I'm a fat nigga. When you fat niggas put on air bubble shoes, we kind of pop one in the middle somehow.
You know, you're a young person. Do you follow what goes on social media?
I do, but to be honest, I try to stay like super disengaged. I'm sick of every time I go on social media, it's always some sad shit.
That's
always
true.
Either some sad or some overly opinionated ass argument.
Yo, when I say overly opinionated, like, that shit crazy.
I don't know.
I never seen so many people care about other people's business in my motherfucking life.
Like,
why y'all?
What is we doing?
I think a lot of times some of those businesses be triggering.
Because they go through it in real life?
They go through it and they don't get the same result that they got. Like, let's take Kiki and Darius for a moment, right? Can you just
let's
just go straight to that, okay? It's the biggest thing that happened since the last time we potted, right? So for those of you guys who don't know, first of all, where the hell you been? Shit, because we late on the topic. Keke Palmer went to an Usher concert.
Keke, do you love me?
And Usher did what he always does, is he'll take somebody out the crowd, he'll serenade them here and there, and, you know, they have their moment with Usher. Keke Palmer happened to be the one that got chose because, let's be honest, if you got a room full of women and you got a famous one in front of you, you're gonna grab the famous one. It's gonna go viral, okay? Thanks. So apparently Kiki's baby daddy was there with him, Darius. I don't even know this nigga's last name. He just Keke baby daddy right now. And there was this whole uproar about the fact that he felt a certain way about the moment. Now, the internet, when it first dropped, was confused because some people thought he was upset about the outfit she had on. Because once again, people were projecting themselves in that situation. It come to find out it wasn't about the outfit. It was the fact that she was looking lovingly into this nigga's eyes and she was hypnotized in the moment. So now it's like, oh my God, why are you stressing the fuck out over this situation, my dog? You got so many different opinions. You got some dudes like, my girl would never, I would have, you know, had to whoop Usher ass in that moment. First of all, you wouldn't have.
You see what happened with Tom.
You wouldn't have got past the security. Number two.
Oh, you never seen that episode of the Boondocks? Boondocks?
Let it go.
Okay. I always have. That's my story of why Usher is a villain. He's always.
Want you.
And then, on top of that, you had some people was like, but why are you mad? You're Kiki's baby daddy. You won. You know what I'm saying? Like, you got a baby with her already. You living good. And then you just got some folks who are just being facetious to begin with. So let's start with you, Diamond. What was your interpretation of the situation?
I feel like, to be honest, it was the hug. It was the dance. It was the, like, but me being in her position, I guess, it's just like, it's Usher. That's one of the people that, as in our generation, a young girl, it was like, ooh, Usher. You know what I'm saying? So I feel like in that moment, she really was just having fun. She didn't mean no disrespect by it. But obviously, wearing what she had on and having this new mommy sexy body.
That's all disrespect.
Wait. Having this new sexy ass all body disrespect. And a man at home.
Intended.
You know, it was very disrespectful. Now, in the case where people are looking at it like it's Usher's fault, Usher is the real villain. Usher is an entertainer. That's his show. So he's gonna give people a show. You know what I'm saying? He gonna give them something to remember, so to say. Especially if you have another famous person who Keke Palmer got a name herself.
Can I ask you a question? If you got a boyfriend. And this is you. Do you?
That's where I was going. Right.
I feel like would you know what too much is?
Right. Okay. So as Usher being this entertainer, right, he's only doing what he is allowed. So me being me, I probably wouldn't have did the hug. I probably would have did a little two-step with him. You know, kept it cute, kept it simple because I know my nigga watching. But I don't know. You know when you're in a relationship and you know when you're not. He don't know that. So him just coming out as a regular ass nigga doing what a nigga would do or a entertainer, you know what I'm saying? It's up to me to be like, hey. And like I said, back up, do a little two-step. You know how that shit go.
Okay, let me ask you this question. Have you ever watched the Janet Jackson concert?
Yes.
Okay. So you know that at some Janet Jackson concerts, there's a moment where a gentleman gets brought up on stage and it can be pretty intense. You went to the Janet Jackson concert with Bae and Bae gets pulled up on stage. How are you feeling about this situation?
And that's literally what I had a discussion about, like with my guy at the time. Pretty much him saying, you know, how would you feel if it was me?
Damn, at and the time. It's like, that time, was 2 weeks ago. What? Niggas be in and out like, oh, what the fuck?
Niggas
weird. Is crazy.
So he asked me, like, you know, how would you feel if it was me, if I got pulled up there? And I would be pissed because it's like, first of all, that's a badass bitch. Second of all, how do you be mad that Janet Jackson pulled your nigga up there.
And that's where I'm
You know what I'm saying?
At,
do you let that person have fun because you know it's not going to go nowhere?
It's a moment or, that they'll never experience again.
Yeah, or do you genuinely let it play out? I mean, me as a woman, I am not insecure. So being in that moment, I'm going to be like, get that shit, babe, but I'm going to expect you to know your limits. We not up there touching pussy. We not up there.
First of all, Janet ain't going to let you do that.
Okay, that's what I'm saying. 9 times out of 10, she going to make your hands be right here. So I'm watching you get a strip tease without her stripping, basically.
I feel like there's a, difference in there somewhere. And when I find it.
Yeah, because let's not be double standard if we going to go there.
The level of extremes between the two is the reason why I use Janet more so than, let's say, Chance the Rapper situation.
Right.
Is because the behavior that these niggas was going in is as if Usher literally was rubbing his dick all on her the way niggas was acting.
Okay, here's my opinion. Like where Janet and this is different is like, okay, so you know when you get on stage with Janet, she gonna lay you on this board, she gonna restrain your hands and feet, and she got you at her mercy. Like, you know you can't do nothing. Even if you wanted to, you can't. You in this fucking, you to let her tie you the fuck up, nigga.
They have to do that because niggas is weird.
All I'm saying is, you got tied up. Versus Usher with a microphone looking at you, and then you got your arms around me. I think that's a little different versus, I think it's different.
I don't know.
If I'm standing there with the mic doing, singing my shit, and you put your arms around me, you are now touching me. I ain't did nothing but my job.
But like I said, if Kiki
and then
was,
like again, I'm singing with a microphone and your hands are all over me, fam. I'm here doing my job. You are crossing lines because you're touching.
It was harmless though, to be honest.
But why you keep if it's harmless, keep your hands to yourself.
It was very harmless. Like
I want to see how harmless it's gonna be when you come home.
No, I think it only became something that he got like fucked up by because she looked it good, ass out, titties out. Yeah. Now if she had on some big ass granny dress, he wouldn't care.
Facts. I wouldn't have cared either.
He wouldn't give a fuck because it's like, oh, okay,
but another thing,
it's Kiki.
Here's my
question. But he like, oh no, my baby didn't got some. She didn't got some titties. Why, she didn't got some ass.
Why we even? Yeah. Why we even here at this point? Because I feel like
oversharing.
We going to have a conversation about all of this before you leave this house.
But that's the thing. Even then, the outfit wasn't the issue because he approved the outfit. He even was like, bitch, when we get home,
so if
that ass.
So if it's not about the outfit, what you
she
bitching for?
Too happy.
Sure,
she
did. She
was too engaging,
lot,
but
it's Usher, fam. Some
else
in life, you just got to eat.
That's why he was mad, because who wouldn't think Usher would take that bitch?
But you know what it is?
Usher would take
I think the issue is, not. I guarantee you, his boys got in his ear.
Yes.
I guarantee you, in the video,
that's a lot
hit the
of
internet,
what be happening.
Niggas was like, hey, man, you just going to let niggas all up. And niggas got in group chat and got the ribbon dog, and that shit got deep, and that nigga got mad. Because, look, he didn't even go to Kiki about it. He immediately went to the internet about it.
Bro,
niggas was going to jump on his side.
To go to the internet, that's nasty work, bro. That's gay.
It is. A lot of shit niggas do this day and age is really, really sus.
Wow.
Really?
Oh my God. So I couldn't imagine just sitting on the internet with a bunch of niggas I do not know discussing my bitch. That's crazy.
And that's what happened. And then,
because really, if this wasn't a moment of oversharing, he wouldn't have been mad.
He wouldn't have been mad. I
but because it was blasted for the world.
It's because his girl was famous.
Yes.
That's what it was. Because if you pay attention, like, if she wasn't Kiki Palmer, if she was just like Trakeisha Palmer off of 3rd in Oklahoma,
who cares?
No one cared. But because it's True Jackson VP Kiki Palmer, Akilah and the beat. You know what I'm saying? Now it's different.
Can we call it? Can we call her Cheeky Palmer?
Yeah, she could definitely be Cheeky Palmer.
Cheeky Palmer. Got that ass out. Yeah, but you gotta stay off the internet with your feelings, bro.
No,
nah, you can't do that.
No, hold on now.
So I just didn't like the way he responded. Not go to the whole, you're a mom. You're a mom. It's the outfit. You're a mom. Bro, but you just posted her in a panties and bra set.
You cannot slander your baby mama. You
titties looking fat. That's looking fat.
We get enough of that in Tubi.
That is, yeah.
But speaking of Tubi movies,
that's bitch nigga.
What's the last Tubi movie you ever watched? One.
I don't watch Tubi.
Speaking of movies, dog, I actually finished Secrets of a Side Chick. I forced myself to finish it.
That was terrible.
It was terrible.
I just recently watched If I Can't with the guy.
What did you think about? Okay, so since we're here, since lately, okay, so for those who don't know,
these sound like really, really bad movies.
They're not bad movies. See, contrary to popular belief, they're not bad movies. I think that because of the platform it's on and the acting is not what we're used to in big box office movies, we tend to look down on it. Because to me, honestly, a lot of Tubi movies, a little bit better than BET movies. BET movies don't always be that good. You got Tyler Perry's budget on those. It'll be cool. Hold on, nigga. This shit
his movies don't be that good.
I'm just saying, though, but I'm saying, people, if BET can play these shows, why are we shitting on Tubi? Because it's on a free app.
I'm not saying on you, but universally,
we got some people like you who just won't watch a Tubi movie just because they don't want to. It's Tubi.
But Tubi is starting off how BET started off.
Right. And that's why
with
I like
weird
it.
Ass movies. If you even go on BET Plus, they got a lot of the same ass
it's
movies.
It literally be the same.
I
and there's actual regular movies on there too.
Now, what I will say.
I just hate they got commercials.
What I will say about Tubi is whoever owns this shit, it's very smart. Genius. This is genius. Tubi really getting, and I'm glad everybody getting in on the ground floor. Because one day we are going to wake up and a motherfucker is going to be just like y'all advocating, like, hey, bro, you should check this out. What is it on? They're going to say, Tubi, you're going to open your fucking phone or your smart TV and look for the Tubi app, and that shit going to say $9.99.
But that just means
real shit.
But that
means I'm not saying it's a bad thing.
That means that somebody's doing something. If they're going to, again, this is what's going to happen.
They're going to get paid for this shit.
This is what's going to happen. Okay? Now, if you find a good series of movies, back it up. You find an actor that you kind of fallen in love with, you start going down the rabbit hole and watching all the bullshit they in. Because that's how I ended up on If I Can't. Because Crystal the Doll, which was the best friend, who wasn't shit, she is in this, but she's also been in several other movies, including the little series, The Dirty D, that everybody been watching lately.
Right.
Okay.
So she's in all these different. Been following her for a minute. Then I started noticing that the main chick in If I Can't, Minda Moore, I think that's her name. Don't quote me on that. I know the first name is Minda. She's actually the one been writing all this shit. So there's at least about 10 to 15 movies and shows on Tubi written by her. So off top, big ups to her.
Big
up to her because she literally
Tubi
and what's crazy is if you look at some of these women on there, the first thing you think is something negative, like another big booty bitch. And it's like, here it is. She the writer.
Yeah, and then you find out the man. For some odd reason, it's her voice that gets me.
It's the voice.
I actually love her voice. It's annoying at times, but I love it. But she be writing these roles where we have come to the conclusion she got to die in every scene she in.
That's crazy.
Every movie she in, she kind of dies in it. This is not even a spoiler, people.
Not a spoiler. It's a fact.
It's a fact.
She's going to die.
She's going to die. May not be season one, but by the end of season two.
Gemini, you're going to die twice.
But If I Can't actually was triggering for a lot of people.
It was.
It was very triggering for a lot of people.
Why was it triggering?
Well, spoiler alert for those who ain't watched it. If you ain't watched it, your damn fault.
That's true.
Plot's about the same in every goddamn movie anyway.
Same way you seen them all?
And damn near can figure kinda out what's going to happen. You like kind of figure out what's going to happen next. So basically the movie ended wrapped up with the chick dating the drug dealing boyfriend. Drug dealing boyfriend basically said in so many words, if I can't have you, nobody can. So if you know.
But come to find out, he was actually the one who killed her first husband.
He's the one who did that. But we're not even going to talk about that. Plot twist, shouldn't even be told. He literally ended up killing.
This shit's terrible.
He ended up killing her first son, who's not even his. End up killing her and then copped out and killed himself. And in Milwaukee, it's real triggering for a lot of people because over the course of the last years, we've had a lot of baby daddies killing their baby mamas for the simple fact that they didn't want to keep putting up with your bullshit and wanted to move on. And then we've had situations where they've even gone live prior to or even during the actual killing. So for a lot of people, it triggered these memories and these thoughts and stuff like that. And I don't think that that's what the initial reason for the ending was supposed to be to happen, because they're all the way in Detroit. They don't know. Well, I can't say they don't know, but I don't think when she wrote this, she was thinking about what was going on in Milwaukee, because people think that they write these movies and they done within like 3 months. No, sometimes this shit's be like a whole year, year and a half before we even see.
Well, I mean, you right. You right.
To
from
be
the
honest, I wouldn't. I don't mind it being something that she kind of brought to the light, because like you said, it's becoming a norm here for sure.
Right.
Triggering, yes, but very much so needed to be seen.
Right. But there's this light-skinned dude with braids, like two braids. Looked like he could play like light-skinned Snoop. Dog be in all these movies, and he damn near played the same role in every movie.
I didn't see him in nothing else.
And typecasting out of the gate.
Child Support. He popped up on Dirty D.
Why is that? Like, why is that the name of him? What's this one saying?
It gives like first 48 captions, like
Child Support. Shit, there's a movie on there called PPP Loan.
What?
See, here's the thing. They don't make creative titles, bro. Like, there's no catchy title. It's just like
the name of these movies.
That's why
sound
don't
like
nobody want to watch them.
And
though.
I think that's why, because they don't put effort in the title. They just get
So I don't think people shit on Tubi. It's just when you hear about some shit, it don't even sound appealing.
But maybe people just want to get to the point. But the reason why I bring this up is because, if y'all haven't been paying attention to my Facebook page over the course of the last week, I am going to create my own Tubi movies. And we are.
I would like for you to.
You just want to be in Broken Blunts and Bad Bootleg.
I want you to make your Tubi movies.
And you just want a residual check from Heaven Can't. Heaven's a Call.
I just would like for you to live your dream, brother.
I love that for him.
Only because you want to be in them. You know I'm not going to let my boy die.
I didn't say that I didn't want to be in them. I just, I love that he's passionate about this. He wants to fulfill his dream.
So, my question for both of you guys is, if you were able to create, if I wrote a Tubi movie right now, what do you think your character in the movie would be?
I don't know. I got an on and off switch. I could either be the lawyer that gets you out of your shit, or I could be the ghetto-ass baby mama.
Why can't you be a ghetto-ass baby mama who happens to be a lawyer?
See, that's Tubi type shit.
See, that's what? The Tubi. That's
that might strip at night.
What? She got to pay for college somehow.
It's always a twist.
It's always a twist to it. Nobody is directly what they is. Like the lawyer in the Child Support one. I'm glad
so you're a ratchet baby mama that's a paralegal, and you strip at night to pay for your bar exams. That's where we're going.
That's where we're going, bro.
Wow. I don't even know how you even form a movie around that.
Think about it, bro. There's always got to be
Is this Lawyers Club? Like, what are we doing here at this point?
The drug dealing baby daddy got busted at the club. Because that's where they hide the dope at, in the liquid cocaine.
Am I a pothead in all these movies?
You picking your role, I'm saying.
And honestly, if you the pothead, you might die first.
That is true.
It's not a horror movie, and why are niggas getting shot?
Making a Tubi horror movie, too.
I don't think I would be the pothead in that movie. I don't want to be in it because I'm a guy. Niggas been saying I was a serial killer for years. I think this is my perfect debut.
Did you watch The Blackening yet?
I have not.
No.
Where can I find it?
I watch it online, but it is digitally somewhere.
Yeah.
Not on Tubi, though.
No. You probably got it. It's probably on like Prime Video.
Yeah, it might be on Prime or Max.
If it's under $10, I'll
it's actually kind of good.
I'll purchase.
Kind of good. I like it.
If it's over $10, I'm waiting until they put that shit on the streaming service I pay for.
It might already be on a streaming service.
It should be crazy. They thought I was going to pay $20 to watch fucking Michael B. Jordan and Creed 3. Never.
I didn't even watch Creed 3 yet. I think it's on Hulu now.
No, it's on Prime. It's on Prime.
Yeah.
It's
one of
them. I was like, I will wait until this is free to watch this big nigga knock your ass the fuck out.
So, Diamond, what's your go-to app for movie watching? Because you can't watch Tubi all the time. You got to take a break from Tubi.
Shouldn't watch Tubi.
I'm not gonna lie, I like Stars. They be having some gems. And I like Paramount Plus. 50
Cent has gems.
Yeah.
The rest of that shit.
What is your favorite movie?
The Wood.
Ooh, okay, okay. I fuck with that. I like The Wood.
But then the other one is perfect.
Why? Why?
I love Bernie Mac.
Okay, that's what
he was funny as fuck. And
fun fact, two fun facts in one. So fun fact number one, my dad used to look just like Bernie Mac.
That's crazy.
Fun fact number two, today is his birthday and he would have been 65.
Whose birthday?
My dad's.
Oh, happy birthday.
I said he did it. Not mine.
Oh, yeah, happy birthday. Yeah. Damn, we still can't clap it up for folks?
Might as well clap it up for
folks. Yeah, this is happy birthday to him. Happy heavenly birthday. I don't know, Tom. Don't make it weird, bro.
I'm glad his movie has to be told.
Yes, yeah.
His movie has to be told. Yeah, I have to write his story.
Live action. We should do a superhero movie, too.
Is the world ready?
I always wanted to be in an action movie.
Is the world ready for a another black superhero movie?
Yes.
Yeah, but I feel like because
Black
we like
Adam was weird.
No, that don't count.
Like, I feel like
that don't count. When I say black, I'm talking like Meteor Man ish.
Yeah, see,
because you gotta remember we're making it on Tubi, so it's gotta be ground level.
I feel like we gotta be the contradiction to the Justice League.
The Negro Justice League.
Yeah, but just like it's a parody superhero movie
to all black people.
All black people, and just like parodies.
I gotta figure that out. I gotta get around licensing.
Yeah, you guys just think of some terrible fucking superheroes.
And they only for the hood.
Only for the hood. Like, you know. If we had a speed nigga, he would only be fast when it came to running from like the police.
Literally. Or some type of guns.
Yeah, like if you got a pistol, he out of there.
So that'd you said you would be in a, you want to be in an action. What would your action movie look like? Like what kind of action movie? Are you in like Taken? Are you in like John Wick? Like what? Are you in a Mortal Kombat ish movie?
I don't know. It's kind of giving Proud Mary.
With like, Taraji P. Henson, that one was trash, but
oh damn!
I would want to see a black.
I'm sorry, it's not for me.
I would rather see. Is Proud Mary like a black Taken where they took her kids and then she?
Not really. Proud Mary is more like assassin-ish. Okay. Like she assassin. She do.
It's an hour and a half of Taraji P. walking around with this big ass
John Wick,
nickel plated 4 or 5 shooting motherfuckers. That's what this movie is.
I've never seen it.
You didn't miss much.
Apparently, I missed a lot.
Taraji P. is not.
No, you would not talk about the ghetto queen.
I love her. It's one of those that Taraji,
it's because she came from Jody Baby Mama.
No, it's just it's certain,
I don't think that was her first movie, was it?
No, it wasn't. People you just can't see doing certain things in movies.
Yeah.
Like how she mentioned Black Adam. That wasn't The Rock being a superhero. Like that was he was The Rock minus the actual good catchphrases.
Yeah.
Like if he'd have slid a jabroni, a candy ass, we might as well have been on Monday night. So it's like, and you look at him like, damn, I can see The Rock being a superhero. Then when we got it, I was like, he shouldn't be a superhero ever again. Nah, I'm cool on Rock being a superhero.
We'll say Baby Boy was her first role.
Cause she had technically.
Because she had did two smaller roles in 2000 and 1998, but Baby Boy was literally where we really.
Her first starring as a starstress. So, Miss Diamond, are you single?
Diamond is single.
I don't like how you said that in third person.
Diamond is single.
So, do you have someone else in the bag that's not?
So Diamond got invited to the speed dating event next week.
She got to relax. I love her, but she got to relax.
What she do? She is recruiting.
You cannot hit everybody with the, hey, I have a podcast. You just can't do that.
It wasn't the podcast. Okay.
Actually, she caught me and she was on live. And she was like, come get in my live. Are you single? And
I was like, yeah, that's what I'm talking about. That's how she got it. It was like, just jumped up. Women be too comfortable around other women asking women questions. Yes. Like, I get it. Michelle is a peaceful person. She's not a threat to anything.
Right, she don't mean no harm.
She don't mean no harm.
But it's wild.
Just logically thinking out loud, if everybody just talked like that, niggas would be locked up.
Yeah, just as a man, I don't think I could.
As a man, I could.
How she approached y'all as a nigga, I could never do that.
It was very woman friendly though, because compared to what we were talking about earlier, saying how women approaching women and they don't, it's a mug or it's you looking funny or like, no, she embraced me. She's like, oh, your outfit is cute. Like, you know, so it was more welcoming. Now, if she was like, oh, hey, like you single, it would have been like, why? Like,
yeah, hey, that's how some women, that's just kind of.
But she was very welcoming.
Michelle is like a walking call center.
Yeah, it made me want to be like, oh, why? What's up?
She just likes, as soon as she say, hey, I just feel like you about to sell me something. Yes. You're like a sleazy used car. Like a sleazy used car salesman.
And you buy right into whatever she's selling, too.
Have you seen it?
Mm-hmm. You know what? Me and her had a conversation about that.
I would buy it in a heartbeat. Buy it in a heartbeat.
We had a conversation about that a while
My God. Oh, my God.
What?
Just man, it's lovely.
You seen it too?
It's lovely over there.
Is that really what drew you to it?
It might have been. You're not wrong. Because if this is
that was the second thing.
If this is what's approaching me, whatever you
was the second thing.
If you is you and Shell is Shell and you look like that and you invite me to an event, it must be other people that look
like this. You exactly.
Gotta be other people that look like you.
And you telling me that I can find
that's why she get niggas to come to these things, because they be like, it gotta be more people. She like one of those how can you describe it? Like if you was to fall off a spaceship and boom, and she's the first person that greets you, be like, it gotta be more y'all around this motherfucker. Yeah. Somewhere. Yeah. Take me to your leader.
And I've never saw her like and she do podcasts. She promote good shit. And I was like,
am I wrong? Am I wrong?
It's not whether you're right or wrong.
Where you been?
It's
how I describe things.
It's just funny,
bro. Man,
that's your friend.
That's my friend.
You brung her into our world. So.
Are you blaming me for the positive aura that she shines? Nigga, Shine Your Light podcast. Check it out all the time.
Yes,
because God is good.
It's not a bad thing.
Nigga, I bring positivity into your life.
It's a goddamn lie.
I do.
That was an exception to the rule. You are.
I know. I brought somebody else that was positive. You know her, Grand Rising.
Hey.
Power to the people.
That's my little homie.
Tom, I'll be blessing you with some positive energy.
I'll be bringing positivity to her more than she bring it to me, but she definitely can turn a frown upside down. Definitely. But
what else you got on the docket, Tom?
Interpretation. So what? Recently, social media has
like
been...
sign interpretation?
Sometimes. I'd be careful now before you summon an evil spirit, bro. Yeah, you watch enough anime.
Okay,
see,
it's just came out.
You know the tribe is here to show fault. But,
we walk outside and it's 10-foot tall naked people, fam.
You need to stop watching Attack on Titan.
That's what it was. I was like, I walked in bro room. I'm like, what is this? He's like, it's Attack on Titan. He's sitting there eating his chips. I'm like, nah, this is wild. You don't think this is weird?
Right.
But again, the anime culture, I respect it. I don't get it, but that's your bag. I fucks with it. Whatever's your bag is your bag. I like wrestling. And people will still be like, hey, you know it's fake, right? That is my biggest pet peeve when people ask me, do I still watch wrestling? They're like, you know it's fake? No shit,
I don't
nigga.
I think it's fake, though. Some of that shit don't be fake.
It's not fake. Wrestling? It's predetermined.
Yeah, I used to be into it more than I am now. Now I do kind of feel like it's like, y'all just
get it. It's a soap opera.
Y'all just doing shit.
It's a soap opera.
Before,
opera
you know,
gymnastics.
Rikishi and all the Rock and all them, I was like,
I'm so sick and
he
tired.
He beat his ass.
Of every woman who said they used to watch wrestling.
It always circles back to the Rock. It does.
Fuck, like, damn, it was other niggas that was there.
But this is, they was
true,
watching
but
it for
the
dark
Rock
nigga taking
super,
his shirt off.
He's super relevant now. So that's why I just said his
name. I'm just saying, because like,
he relevant. And
it's funny because you named
you're not gonna look and be like the Undertaker. Nobody's thinking about him right now. Yes, he was big.
Wait, Tom. Let me don't do it.
But
I know what you want to do, but I can't let you do it because we just got on. Don't put your feelings on the internet.
No, I was gonna say you named two cats who it, I would say it's funny because the two cats are the reason why you watched wrestling. There's younger versions of them right now.
Oh, and the women
making wrestling the greatest thing ever.
And women love them.
And that lustfulness that you used to have for The Rock, guarantee you, and I like girls, this nigga Roman is going to have you even wetter.
Pause.
I had to say,
why do we not have a...
You want to know? No, no. I like girls.
I know you like girls,
but you know, when you talk to any moms,
a good pause is a good pause. Sometimes you got to pause that shit.
How many times have we talked to women who do watch wrestling, and that's the first nigga they bring up? Every time.
He is relevant, and he is fine, and he still got his youthfulness.
You and these long-ass lashes.
I would imagine a 38-year-old should still have his youthfulness.
No, we're not going to do ageism.
Yeah.
He's 38!
We got enough of that conversation going on in the group chat right now.
About
old niggas not being relevant.
Hey man, some old niggas just ain't. But wrestling is different about relevancy than like life. You are here today, gone tomorrow.
So interpretation, where would you get him with that?
So lately,
is this more like people reading the room?
We're getting there. So lately, the internet has been black internet has been in the frenzy because the AIs have shook up the world again. Recently, a new AI application came out called
Remy.
The Remini, depends on how you say it, where they are literally are taking your face and putting you on different bodies and making people look beautiful. Because I'm not going to lie to you, that blue suit on me, I'm fucking sexy.
Okay? I want to see.
Fucking sexy.
You don't put your AI pictures on the screen for the world to see. We got that kind of technology, Tom.
I know we do, but I ain't gonna move forward.
You sure? Because you look like You look like the Black James Bond.
And I'm cool with that. But I think what really started getting me irritated, because first of all, I already know that all these AI softwares are leading to something else down the road. Eventually, you're gonna get some form of identity fraud that's going to happen because it's getting a little bit too advanced. The AI is going to get smart and take over the world like we always expect. But I think my thing is niggas on the internet don't know how to not take shit personal. Like, I was minding my business, scrolling through, seeing all my friends with the AI photos. And then in the mix of it, I seen someone make this extremely long post talking about, oh, these AIs is fucking up people's perception of self-imagery and they're making you thinking that you're supposed to be at a certain standard of beauty because everybody is skinny. And then now you're starting to have self-doubt because if you are a big person and now you look like this, you feel like you ugly. And I'm like,
it's always one woke nigga fucking up the fun on the internet.
Nobody that I know who's been using the AI sits here and says, oh, damn, I need to change who I look. I got a lot of people, like my skinny folks, it looked like a regular photo to them. My big people, we end up having big heads and small bodies because we big people.
That nigga didn't look nothing like me.
You just... Not you look like an extra in a fucking James Bond movie.
I was like, damn, fam, my neck, look, what is this?
But it was.
Then I'm like, y'all got me next to these unrealistic. Well, I couldn't get a truck or something. I got a nigga next to a Ferrari.
Oh, shit.
Because the way the imagery looked, it was never meant for it to be realistic. Like, people were freaking out because they were allowing you to put your face on a baby's body or de-aging you. It's like, have you not watched Marvel movies? They've been had de-aging technology.
Right. Yeah.
You know, the whole Captain Marvel movie was done in the 90s.
Facts.
You know,
niggas still don't know where they got that fucking Blockbuster storefront.
They used the last one in the country. I think it's in Seattle.
And they blew that motherfucker to smithereens.
There's still a Blockbuster out there. Some people still renting DVDs.
Smithereens.
You better not.
Some people do. Not everybody wants to move into the... One, old people don't like change.
Now, some changes you just got to get with.
No.
You don't got to get with all the changes, but some of the changes you can't.
Old people don't like change. They and that's why they are always the ones calling call centers. Fussing.
Like, bro, like some shit you just, like if you still got a VCR, fam, like, all right, give it a fucking rest, man. They eventually upgraded to DVDs. I mean, shit. You ain't got to have no streaming services, but goddamn it, a VCR, bro.
I had a VCR.
Had you still some got one?
Movie, certain movies.
I sold it. It was a whole TV, and it had a VCR. But I still had tapes and shit. So I was like,
right, like some movies.
2021, you still had tapes?
Yeah, some movies were better on tapes. Prime example, and I use your shirt as an example. The original Star Wars, the 6, 7, and 8. Is that 6, 7, 8? No, 4, 5, 6. My bad. 4, 5, 6. They changed it like 5 or 6 times. So unless you have a tape from when it first came out, you wouldn't see all the changes that happened into it, all the extra shit that kept getting changed over and over again. So for some people, having those tapes is literally like printed gold. You don't want to get rid of it.
That is true.
And then
my grandma was a hoarder too.
Right. And you growing up in the Nickelodeon eras, man, you're not going to tell me you're not going to have some joy when you seen that orange VHS tape. You knew exactly what that movie was.
What?
Facts.
It's either Good Burger or I think it's Rugrats.
Rugrats for sure.
Rugrats, Good Burger, and Wild Thornberry.
Oh, yep.
All three of them was the orange tape. Shit. All three was the orange tape. So you go by Granny House and Granny found your orange tape, you know you was going to have a good time.
Mm-hmm.
So if you're going to sit here and watch Rugrats, yeah, you could go on a streaming service and watch it, but it didn't hit the same as putting that VCR tape in there and getting pissed off because somebody rewind your tape so you didn't get a chance to be where you left off at. Nostalgia.
I feel your nostalgia.
Nostalgia makes a lot of people do a lot of shit. That's why there's a lot of chicks who go back to their baby daddy. Nostalgia. That's not nostalgia. Now you're talking about me.
That's top five.
Why do bitches go back to their baby daddy?
Nostalgia.
Elaborate.
You want that old thing back. I mean...
Before or after the baby?
Let's say before.
Damn, how many times have y'all broken up?
No, well, I'm not gonna say broken up. That's taking it too far.
Took a break.
I feel like the us before the baby had different stipulations. So
I just like how you dancing around
the answer. Like, so it's like we wasn't breaking up. We only really broke up once. And then it kind of just stayed there.
Do you know
there.
The shortest distance between two things is a straight line?
Okay.
I just want you to know. It was only once.
Okay. How long was the breakup?
We still broken up.
Okay. But I guarantee.
How old is this baby? Now I have other questions. Now
it sounds like the baby is too old. She's referring to baby and not child. So that means they're usually under 5.
He's one. You know when they what they say when he won, you ain't done. I'm just kidding.
No. Hold on to that.
So this breakup is recent.
No, hold on to that because that's actually where we're getting ready to go.
So this is like fresh.
This is very fresh.
This just happened.
He's wanted some change. His birthday was in March.
I'm talking about your breakup.
Yeah.
It was
like last year, October-ish. November-ish.
Oh, so y'all ain't really broke up.
Oh, yes, we are.
No, but here's the thing. Okay. So
he got a chance to do right.
Right. And this is my
like, make it up.
Right. Like you ain't completely saying fuck you yet.
No, you ain't. So if you go, let's say you go to Lachelle's event. Okay, next week, and you meet a guy and you want to entertain that guy, and you know you have to go through the whole entire process of getting to know somebody, getting comfortable with them, seeing where they head, and the whole dating process with purpose, right?
Mm-hmm.
At the end of the day, your baby daddy, or I hate that word,
your, I do kid, too.
Your child's father, y'all broke up because he did something wrong, or did you do something wrong?
Right, I was gonna say, what if it was me? No, it was definitely some wrongdoing.
Okay, there was some wrongdoing. So let's just say during this time frame, he matures. Whatever things that he wasn't doing, he fixed. He get himself together. He got better stability. Now he's good. You got this great guy who you're building something with, but you got this old thing who now got itself together. It's like an episode of Love It or List It. I got this brand new house that does everything I need, but if you just fix these couple of things that's wrong with the house I'm living in,
I won't move out.
I'm not moving.
Yeah.
Damn, that was a really good metaphor that you just used right there.
Huh, that's because that's what we do, right? So that's what we do.
That's why you on this show as your debut.
That's what
I know that's right. Ooh, I know that's right. Breaking the ice. You know what though? And that's going back to what me and Kendall was just talking about. Like I told her, in this day and age right now, I want the house. I want the family. I want the big backyard. Right. But it's like, it just seems so fucking far-fetched. It seems so unrealistic in this generation right now. Like, we were best friends before any of this. And to be honest, I feel like after the baby, it either makes or break y'all as a couple. Or as friends, as co-parents, as whatever the fuck, you know what I'm saying? And y'all right, for sure. It is hard to... You know what I'm saying? You, when you want something, especially when you have a child with somebody, if this not something that's just a one night stand or just like, you know, you've known this person, y'all love each other, y'all been together, you expect more out of the situation. And I think that's where I went in wrong. I felt like it was supposed to be this big fairy tale that we always talked about.
You're not wrong for that.
You're not wrong for that, but I always tell, because I tell Juan this almost every year we grow old because we 10 years apart in age, right? Mm-hmm. So I'm a whole age bracket above this nigga. As you start to go up, there's going to be certain things that you're just not going to give a fuck about no more. And as you get older and you start giving a fuck less about unnecessary shit, the regular shit starts to become more important. Right now, you guys are sitting in an age category where settling down is on nobody's mind. Okay? Fact. Nobody should be wanting to settle down between 21 and like 27. But a lot of y'all come into y'all 20s ready to
be a wife.
Unlock that.
But you know right. what? They some of us, some of us as women, though, that's all we see from our mom. So you got some people who, you know, they get this housewife mom who taught them this, and that. And then you get this other one who like, I don't give a fuck what time you come in the house. You grown. They fucking, they ended up pregnant. Not saying it like that's the only statistics, but you get what I'm saying? Like, more so, it's coming from what we see as women growing up from kids. Like, you know, I saw my mom. She never bashed my dad. Even when her and him were on bad terms, she never talked shit about him. She never wanted this image of they were into it for us. You know what I'm saying? I've always seen them love each other no matter if they were together.
Right.
So me growing up and having him as a baby daddy or the father of my child now, that was my best friend. So I
was
try to go
best friend before.
Both. So I try to go into it knowing like, okay, even if this shit don't work out, we have to still remain how we used to be. Like because not only was that what I saw, but you know, I saw my mom being like wifely, you know, but being a hard worker, always at work, you know, but always trying to make time, always trying to, you know, make sure we were straight, but always still trying to include him. And I feel like me seeing a lot of those things became something that like, oh, I want to do that.
Which is great.
I want to be like that.
And at your age, that's a rare mentality this day and age. I'm not saying it shouldn't be there. We should have more like that, but then let's flip the coin on the other side with him. Has he seen that kind of adultness going on prior to before y'all crossed that line? Because
I think his story is definitely completely different from mine. I will say that.
And that could change the narrative of him appreciating what you're trying to present.
Yes.
At this young of age. Because in his mind, I'm 20 something. I'm not saying that I'm supposed to go out here and fuck everything under the sun, but I got to go out here and figure out what adulting look like for me. Because he may want the big house and all that stuff, but he may want to start off with apartments first. He may want to have roommates with his guys and live that wild boy life first to get that all out of his system and then settle down. You know, not everybody wants to be in a relationship first, because 20 years from now, you're only 46, 47 at that point. And now here you are 46, 47, like, I don't want to be in this relationship no more because I missed out on so much in my 20s. You know what I'm saying?
But I'm a firm believer in if you know, you know. Like, don't get me wrong. I'm going to keep it 100. I can do both. I can go out, do me, talk to a bunch of niggas, go on a bunch of dates, fuck who I want to fuck, talk to who I want to talk to, but I can also really lock in. I feel like sometimes men use that as a cop-out because when you know, you know. When you want to be with somebody, you're going to make sure you do what's necessary to keep them.
Now, let me ask you this question. Does he know that you'll always be there for him?
Sadly, yes.
And that's another reason why he moves the way he moves. Because I can go out here, Donnell Jones, I still got lust inside of me, so I'm going to go out here and fuck all these bitches, but I'm not going to hurt you on purpose. I'm going to go fuck all these bitches, but I need you to stay exactly where you are, so when I'm done fucking these bitches, we can go and be the family we're supposed to be.
Right, but I gotta get this fuck off.
You gotta get these fucks off.
I get these fucks off.
So I need you to not have anybody else, so he keeps being your friend, he keeps being a great co-parent, he keeps presenting himself in the way of things that you love about him. Yes. So you'll never let the love for him diminish down so someone else could step in and actually love you like you're supposed to be loved.
I've definitely sabotaged a couple.
And I know you have.
Bonds and experience that me actually liking a man. I'm talking about like, yes, he's the one. And then my baby daddy call and I'll be like, you said come outside.
That's crazy.
You said come outside.
That's why I ain't got no girlfriend.
But I'm going to keep it 100. I've never just crept off. Like, if I'm really fucking with somebody, you know what I'm saying? It only becomes me entertaining, I guess, my baby daddy, when the person who I didn't try to invest this time in, it's like it's always something. And I think that's why we go back to our comfort. Because here it is, I done invested all this time into you. Now we're talking about meeting kids. Now we probably didn't have sex or whatever the case may be. And you turn out to be a fuck nigga. Why wouldn't I go back to my old
house?
But
here's my question. Is your fear of him possibly being a fuck nigga actually stopping you from even experiencing life?
No.
Because if you go through all the stages of the dating phase and you find out like, okay, I really want to be more with this person. And then all of a sudden baby daddy pops in with the usual bullshit enough to get his foot through the door. And now you done let this dude go. Or you was like, damn, I really want to be back with my baby daddy, but I like this dude. Are you finding reasons to label him as a fuck nigga to run out the situation so you could go be with your baby daddy with no problem?
Of course not. Of course not. Because to be honest, like I said, it's to the point where me dealing with somebody, I'm open to, you know what I'm saying, it going wherever it needs to go. Like, at this point, yes, I love who I love. I want who I want. But it's like, us as women, period, we get caught up trying to wait around for what we love or trying to wait around for a motherfucker to get right but it's like, nah, you got to get left at this point. And it's just like, I don't know. I know what comes with my baby daddy. I trust him. I trust some of the moves that he makes. But when you go out and you start trying to put that trust in other people, it's sad to say, but they always show you why the fuck you shouldn't. And that's why it's not even me trying to like, oh, let me try to put this label on you so I can have a reason. No, I'm too 100. Like, I'm going to tell you up front, like, but niggas don't know how to do that. They don't know how to be like, this is what it is, this is what it ain't. I'm going to tell you because I don't want to lead you on. This is what it is, this is what it's not. Now, I've definitely, me and my baby daddy stopped fucking with each other. We were both talking to other people, like, everything. Here's your baby. You know what I'm saying? It's not like it's not possible. But in the dealings where, yes, we probably start back talking or we probably start back fucking around, of course, I'm like, okay, drop everybody all over again. You know what I'm saying? Like, it kind of just go in them phases where I'm not talking to him while I'm talking to somebody else. Not at all.
That's why I don't date.
You don't date because
nah, that's not why you
don't
want to
change who right. you are.
So I was going to say, it's nothing wrong with dating. I can't even say as long as you're not fucking them all.
What do you mean change
Ryan? That's up to you.
So you, Juan, personally, have slid into your comfort zone. You are like a great pair of house slippers. Okay. You come home, you do your normal routine. It is what it is. In order to bring a relationship into your comfort zone, you have to not only make space for that person to fit in your comfort zone,
for sure,
but you also have to change a few things that you do to do it with them. You have to go out and enjoy the world from their perspective just as much as you want them to enjoy the world from your perspective. And even though you may like 8 things that this person does out of a list of 10, those 2 things will make you not want to lock it in, because those 2 things, fine as they are, will bother the fuck out of you.
It depends on what those 2 things are.
You say that now.
You a Cancer.
As time goes on,
you a Cancer.
Those 2 things become bigger and bigger, and that will be your cop out to get out.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it really depends on what these 2 things is. Because I don't want you to be sitting here trying to make it seem like I'm just this irrational nigga, dog. Because I'm not.
But I didn't describe you as an irrational. Believe it or not, there are a lot of people like that.
That's, I was just going to say
that.
There's
a lot of people like that. You want love, but you want love on your terms. And you don't want to compromise what those terms are. And in order to get love from the perfect person from you, you got to compromise a few things. And you don't want to compromise.
I feel like if you got a list of 10 things... And I hate 2. I gave you 8. Where was no compromisation on that?
Yeah.
But those 2 things can be nails that just get
in my hands like Jesus.
And that nigga owed me $5.
I'm pretty sure he does.
Gave that nigga some change and he just let it slip out of his hand. He can't hold money to save his life.
Nigga can't hold water.
It's definitely
don't
a
need
lot
to
of
hold
people
water
like
when
you
he
don't.
Turns it into wine.
Ooh.
That's for sure. For
I need that nigga to kick back.
Get busy.
I do want to find love though, eventually.
I do too, but it's not this
love
supposed
to
find you.
However it happens, I'm
but
here
why do
for
people
it.
Say that? Explain to me why you feel like you can't find love and love gotta just find you.
Because the reason being is the way society determines what relationship, socialization, personal, social media, all these different things create walls and barriers that we put up that makes us not even want to give people the opportunity.
Mm-hmm.
So when we go out looking for love, we're looking for a specific thing with specific entities and a specific way it's supposed to look. Our list of 10.
That shit just went through my mind.
Yeah. And then when these 10 are not met, we automatically assume this person's not for us. But when you throw the list out the door and just enjoy life and enjoy the individual, you tend to find out people who love you dearly are right in front of you, plain and simple, and you just got to give that the opportunity. Because a lot of times, and you brought up something that I think that a lot of people need to do more of, but we refuse to do that, is sometimes we got to date our best friend. Sometimes. Not your bestie. Completely different, but you got to start making your friend first.
You can yes. fuck your bestie,
and that's why I think I said that shit about the whole going back. Because when I say going back, it don't necessarily mean that me and my baby daddy be back fucking or we back trying to be in a relationship, but it'd be more so like we back kicking it like how we used to and enjoying each other company, enjoying each other presence.
At the end of the day, for y'all, it can never be back to the way it was.
Facts.
Because number one, there was a whole relationship in between there.
So and the kids involved.
Not even gonna get there yet. Hold on. I'm potting right now. Calm
okay.
down. Okay. there's a whole emotional connection that you guys have. You have legitimate history. So there's the friendship stuff that you did, and then there's the things that you guys actually did together. The things you guys actually did together will always cause problems in how the friendship part is viewed. Because even though uh-huh. relationship-wise, he may be over here and you may be over there, you're going to always get reminded that, well, this guy right here does A, B, C, D. But when I was with him, he did this and that. So if this person does something that reminds you of a positive or a negative, this person can be penalized simply because it reminds you of your friend. Or if you see your child's father moving in a direction that you always wanted him to be in, you're going to gravitate and that love is going to build back up to the surface again, and you're going to want to give it a chance again because he's now projecting what you wanted him to be all to begin with.
Right.
So there's always going to be this conflict. And then let's be honest, starting a new relationship can be very tricky.
Exactly. That
because
was my point.
You have to tell the man that you are dating, or woman, sexuality is a spectrum, that you're dating, you and your baby daddy co-parent like a boss, and y'all still kicking, y'all do family things together, y'all still hang out, And then they'll be like, well, how long has it been since you two broke up? Oh, well, about 18 months. That's going to send a nigga flying right away. Because you have to build the relationship with this new person. And in the back of their head, like, well, damn, what you doing this weekend? Oh, nothing. I'm just, you know, I'm at home and whatnot. Well, you fucking him then. Even though that may not be the case, y'all may not have touched private parts in 2 years for all
right,
we know.
Right.
But it's the fact of the possibility that that thought is always there, and mm-hmm. the actions that match with how y'all move will give that person that inception of a thought no matter what. Thanks. And you can just be really co-parenting like a boss.
Mm-hmm.
So right now, you're going to have issues unless you get a nigga who don't care, and that's usually...
No, I mean, that's where all of my shit goes, honestly. Like, I can dead ass be vibing with a motherfucker, and it don't be me. It be like, oh... You still cool with him like that? Y'all be talking like that? Or I really had a nigga tell me, like, you know, I'm scared to love you because I think you're going to go back to that baby.
You
dad.
Know what?
He's not wrong to feel that way, but you got to respect him enough to put that out there. Because now by him putting that on the table, he's allowing you to either A, prove him right or prove him wrong. The ball is now in your court.
I'm big on reassurance, though. I mean, I've tried to give it to him, but it's like he only seen one way, so I'm not going to try to
because make it. Because it's the same issue about when a chick who wants to date a guy and he says, I got kids, and they ask him how old his kid is, and the kid is under 3, oh, you still fucking your baby mama. I can't date you. With no proof whatsoever, they literally immediately draw that conclusion and end the date right then and there because they feel like he's still fucking her, and that is not the case.
At the same time, people got to grow up.
That's true.
But look, that's why I said, look at the age category she's in. I'm like, not saying that there's not niggas mature in her age group,
like,
but that number,
if I got a baby mama and me and her we don't jam like that no more, but my kid is a year and a half, but me and this bitch won't jam like that no more. When I tell you that I got a baby mama and my kid is a year and a half, apparently this relationship that is done with, that wound's still a little fresh though. It's still there. It ain't been long that it's gone. But at the same time, you got to be mature when you meet me and I lay this out for you that don't hit me with the, don't hit me with that. Oh, you still talk to your, yeah, me and this bitch got a co-parent.
But
it ain't even like that.
But you have to understand.
Would you like to come with me when I drop this little crumb snatching motherfucker off? Right. Would you like to be there when this bitch bring me my kid? Like, what? Yeah, whatever makes you comfortable.
But here's the thing. With women, that's going to be a little bit different because women are emotional.
Niggas got to grow up too.
I feel you. Women are emotional. So for no reason whatsoever, you could be moving on with your life. You could actively have started dating. And that woman is going to be a problem to your child's mother, your mother's child, your baby mama.
Yeah, that matters.
But a simple fact, there's another woman around her kid. Because the thought process that down, there's a mother over here who could possibly mothering better than I am, I automatically have a problem with this woman. Don't know nothing about this
See,
woman.
That's that you need to then, grow up.
Then number two, let's look at the other side of the woman dating you now. What is your relationship with your baby mama? You might be in your head, I'm done with this bitch. This bitch is
but
crazy.
She might
but
not.
This bitch mm-hmm. could be crazy because she's still in love with you.
Yes.
This bitch is doing all this wild, stressful ass shit to you because all she wants you to do is come home and love her. So I'm going to put you on child support because I know by you being on child support, it's going to cut into your finances and you financially can't survive being a single man trying to still help out with your kid on child support. But if you come home and you be with me,
see, that's
I'll take you off child support.
Listen, I feel like it all becomes...
Tubi movie. This was facts. Tubi movie. See, this is why you need to watch it, one.
It all becomes a thing of, at the end of the day, the man putting his foot down. If you have a baby mama or multiple baby mamas or a girlfriend and you know that that's what it is, a motherfucker got to be able to set the record straight. I shouldn't have to wonder about your baby mama. As the baby mama, I shouldn't have to worry about your girlfriend.
But think
like
about the minute he
period.
Put his, but the minute he put his foot down, the minute he showed he's a fucking
it only,
man.
It only becomes that if he's still fucking
well,
his
no,
baby
no,
mama.
Hear me out. But the minute he puts his foot down and he be the man, thought you was gonna suck your thumb. I'm like, girl, mm-hmm. go the fuck up. And the minute he put his foot down and he showed that he a man, she wants him even more now. You a real man now. I had a boy back then when we had kids, but now you grew into a man. Now I want my man that you done become. See. No other bitch is gonna have what I helped build is the mind state. So now she becomes even more of a problem.
This is why I will personally be in jail.
Why I didn't have kids.
Because I would snatch a motherfucker up and politely throw you across the room.
I don't have those issues.
Like, bro, beat it.
Get
the fuck on, man. I'm my life.
One crazy bitch.
I don't got time for that.
And that bitch got a whole bunch of kids and all type of baby daddies, and I don't know why she
fucking kids. One, could you date a woman with multiple kids? You 35. So
35.
It's possible.
Depends on the age ranges of your children.
If you 35, that means to have an 18-year-old, she had to been fucking at like 17, 18.
Right, which is understandable. I can see that.
So.
I don't guess she wasn't fucking at 12.
If she was fucking at 12, I need to check her mental, because she may not have been willingly fucking at 12.
Yeah, you're a lot stable. If you've been popping since
anybody
12,
under 15, I really need to check your mental, because you might have some trauma in there that needs to be
but
worked out.
I mean, 8 kids.
I was jumping rope and hooping.
That come with the game. If that's
hooping got a lot of girls in trouble, too.
Are you a little?
Hula hooping how a lot of chicks perfected their
twerking. That's not answering the question. You can't just lie.
Because you ain't see me.
You see your hula
hooping. Okay. Hula shouted.
Okay.
But 8 kids, though.
Eight kids.
I mean, maturity.
I mean, if that's the game I want to play, then that's the game I'm playing. Right. So I ain't going.
So she checks off all 10 of your boxes. But got 8 kids.
See, that's that one box that I'll be like, that's questionable.
That box big though.
It's a big ass. That's not a box.
Get you some sound effects.
That's a FedEx package.
Let's just say she had all C sections though. So that box is still okay.
I was talking about the box on a piece of paper. But,
I mean, eight kids.
I know it's fire. Somebody thought that shit was fire 8 times. So I know it's good. It's A1 exceptional. Like, you know how you go to these little restaurants, you see a little health inspector board on there? That's an A++.
I'm just saying, bro.
I know it's fire.
So the bedroom is A++. She can work her magic and anything else financially. She done learned how to juggle money like a boss. So you into the equation literally just makes life less stressful.
She gonna flip this account like they flip bricks.
Make it less stressful.
Okay.
But you gotta remember, bro, stepping in as a stepdad, you can't just buy one pair of Jordans on drop day, my nigga. You gotta buy 10.
That's true. Because
that's your pair and her pair.
That's true.
Nigga, stock X is going crazy on drops with you, nigga.
But again, we gotta talk about the age range of these children.
That is true.
Okay, because if we're talking 8 at 35, okay, right. Realistically,
you got some no seven. Twins, you no got twins, some seven.
You definitely got some under 10,
and you got some over the age of 17.
Okay, so let's just say 4 of them. Keep it realistic. Half of them are over 15. The other half are under. So you got some small back talking adults in here. Cause that teenage year is rough.
Yeah.
Remember Noah?
You been my daddy?
Are you?
I don't want to be your daddy.
Half grown, we can bargain. We can bargain.
What's half grown? Is that 12 and up?
What you gonna do the first time?
Wait, were you 12 and up? We can bargain. Like, okay. Like, did you do your chores? If you did your chores, you know, if you doing your shit leading up to drop day, you gonna be good. Cause I know I'm gonna have my money. And I know I'm going to have everybody else money who wear a decent little kid size. You big feet niggas, if y'all washing dishes, taking out garbage, earn your keep. You got to get whatever you want.
What you going to do the first day you come home and you found out that 16-year-old done wore your J's to school?
Oh, my God.
Because you know that's going to happen. They're going
to... I see shit like that.
You talk to him, and he said he had to get his swag up at school because kids was picking on him.
But not if he what sauce did you really have in my shoe if you choking your fucking ankles?
That's your stepdad step in.
What is the sauce you got? I gotta put you on.
He borrow your Oreos.
Oh my god, you gotta have them motherfuckers. I ain't never wore them.
Not the Oreos.
I just said that because I know the shoes he don't fuck with.
Yeah, I don't know.
Okay, let's say you got lucky.
See?
Let's say you got lucky.
Put his foot in my cool grandma, cool whoop his ass.
Let's say you got lucky and you caught some North Carolinas.
Man, don't get my imaginary kid that I don't even have his ass beat.
Like he caught your North Carolinas, though. He came home unscuffed.
Do not put your foot in my shoe, fam. Once you put your foot in my shoe, you can have it. It's yours.
Don't say that out loud because then they just really gonna start rumbling.
That shit, don't put your fucking feet in my shoes.
That's nasty. It's yours.
What about you? You find a guy, awesome guy, sweetheart. Everything going good, financially stable, house is nice, two cars in his garage, living life good, but you find out he got 6 kids.
That's not a deal breaker for me. As long as he take care of his kids. And he take care of me, baby. We good. And when I say take care of me, I'm totally speaking past financials. Like, make sure I'm straight. But like I said, it do depend on the age. Because now I'm the woman. You don't know how these women act.
Now, take consideration, you 26. So he 27 with 6 kids, though. So all his kids,
about his kids, baby.
Maximum under 10.
I'm not gonna lie, still really not a deal breaker. It's not a deal breaker because it's so fucking rare that you're gonna find a nigga without a pass, and that pass is gonna include kids.
You know what's crazy? Here's where we are. Here's where everybody misses the keywords on like Facebook. So kids is not a deal breaker. It's the adjective that you put before kids that will make them a deal breaker.
Badass kids. Ain't nobody gonna say they got badass kids.
Aggressive.
I don't even mind them being bad.
You know.
I don't even mind them being bad.
When you sell a used car, do you tell them that this car had water damage? No, because
keep it a buck. A lot of the times you have a lot of bitter situations that are making them be bad where the mama like, Don't. That ain't your motherfucking mama and talking shit.
You know, that's why you got a lot of men, as a mom, though. Like, give or take a dad. When you a part-time dad, you don't know the ins and outs of everything. I see you on the weekends, holidays. Right. And when you with me, your shit together. You in check. I don't know what you do at home, especially if your mama don't call me to be like, hey, come whip his ass or some shit.
But you should only be calling me to come whip his ass.
I'm just saying, though, Tom.
No, I feel you, but that's
so
added on top of that.
You, as a mom who have your kid all the fucking time, you know when your child is a little too much. Yeah. You know when that nigga a little out of hand.
I feel like that only get disclosed if me and you really working on a relationship and we are actually moving forward to get somewhere.
If you know I'm finna meet your kid,
yeah,
you should probably let me know. Hey, look, little folks, a little wild. Yeah. Like, so I can know what I'm doing when I come in the crib. Like, do I need to keep my hands in my pockets? Is this little nigga a little pickpocket? What the fuck kind of time, Brody, be on? You know what I'm saying? Like, I was like, because I don't want you to go, like, we be chilling, and you step out the room, and you come back, and I done hog tied and punched him in his fucking throat, because he keep fucking around.
Dating the person with kids.
There's no one. But I definitely fuck your kid up.
But I mean, at the same time, though, you also dating someone with kids can be difficult because what the kid knows how to manipulate situations too. So like you and your child's father, y'all could be super cool and your kid only one. But let's just say you start dating and here your kid is 5 or 6. And because they want mommy and daddy to be back together, they misinterpreting your new boyfriend or they presenting your new boyfriend as a horrible person, and now these stories and things are being created about dude that's not true.
That is true.
So now you as the mother is stuck in a situation where you have to choose, do you believe your mate or do you believe your child?
But that comes back to me saying, at the end of the day, kids soak up everything. So I'm not going to be around my kid saying shit that's going to make him even think that me and my baby daddy not good. You know what I'm saying? Even on bad terms, even on the worst of the worst, I am always going to show him that, no, I'm not faking like we're together, but we're family. I'm going to show you we're family. We're all one at the end of the day.
But
when
maybe
you're around
you want mommy and daddy back together, though.
But how? What is back together? Like, is I would have to be around him saying something to have him with the persona of back together. Right now, when he see us, he just see a mommy, a daddy. He don't really know the correlation right now, but
of course,
obviously he knows.
That's why I said about 5'6".
Yeah, obviously he knows, and I get where you're coming from.
Tom watched far too many white movies.
No, but he right though, because to be honest, it is a lot of kids who do that shit. But he do watch too many movies.
Yeah, that's what.
But you right though. That shit right though. No bullshit, because I felt that way too though, but it wasn't when I was 5.
Elaborate.
I was like 10. I'm gonna
break up my mama couple.
Sometimes no.
I was like 10 like, though. I did want my dad and mom back
when
together.
When your mom and dad has been together for majority of your life, then all of a sudden you may not know why daddy got to move out, but then you don't like the fact that daddy house ain't got shit in it because daddy got to start from scratch and mama walking around the house depressed because she doing everything on her own. Then all of a sudden, mama finally meets somebody. It's like, hey, I want you to meet my friend Richard here. And you don't like Richard. Richard ain't did shit to you. He brings you gifts. He bought you fruit snacks. The whole nine yards. You living good with Richard, but Richard ain't daddy. So you going to be like, I don't like Richard. I don't trust
him. Shit, daddy ain't got shit in his house. Richard is okay in my book.
Yeah, he okay to me.
Yeah, man. Richard, make sure we got fruit snacks, nigga. Pops, you struggling, bro.
This box
of cornflakes ain't cutting it, my nigga. We eating Fruit Loops at the crib.
But it become the correlation of respect to me. Like, if it did come down to it, I moved on, I got in a new relationship, I'm going to make sure my partner respects my child. I'm going to make sure my partner respects the father of my child. I'm going to make sure my child respects my partner and respects knowing, like, okay, this not your fucking daddy. Period.
Low-key, I would be cool with my, like, my girlfriend baby daddy. I would try to do my best to be cool with this nigga.
Yes,
I ain't gonna say he gonna be like my bestie, but we gonna be cordial on some level. Like if we having a family thing, and Shorty come in the room like, "Hey, yo, why? I'm thinking about reaching out to my baby daddy because he ain't really got no family. So can he come jam with us?" Cool, because we got some level of respect
trust,
and he
yes.
cool. You come kicking with me and my peoples. You smoke. You drink, yes, bring whatever yes. you bring your amenities. Like
that
I
only happens
be,
when they're not still fucking. Yeah. I'm sorry.
I would want to be on some level of commonality with my girlfriend's baby daddy.
Facts.
And I would
That's
want
how it's supposed
I would
to be.
Want him to feel the same way. Like if you is having something at your crib and for the kid and you want folks to
But a lot of baby daddies do be like, bitter. You know, we talk about women mama. A lot, but the baby daddies be bitter. It gives very much welcome to death row. Niggas don't be wanting you to be with nobody else.
All right, because niggas is crazy. That's the niggas.
Don't want nobody.
That's the niggas y'all choose. That's the nigga y'all choose to date. As long as folks ain't doing harm to my kid, sure, you can raise that little motherfucker when I'm not there.
Right.
That's cool.
I don't mind that. I mean, if there is someone in my baby daddy life, you know what I'm saying, who is giving off mother vibes or giving off something or some type of genuine love for my kid that she did not push out, I can't do shit but respect that.
How long do you wait to before you try to have that sit down conversation with her?
The girlfriend?
Yeah. Like how long of the dating process? So if
I'm not gonna lie.
So you probably gonna know he dating her long before it gets right. serious. So when do you sit down and have that conversation with her about this is where I would like us to be as friends? Because you got to remember, at the end of the day, you in a particular place because you're both best friends and child's mother simultaneously. So you want to meet her as, ooh, let me see who's dating my friend to see if she's good enough for him. But then at the same time, let me see who this woman is that's going to be around my kid.
Yeah, because that's more so where I'm at with it. At that point, I don't give a fuck who good enough for you because it ain't me. So fuck that hoe. Fuck that hoe.
I'm
more so want to be your friend because you're around my child. I don't want no bad blood with us if you're around my child. If you don't like me, I don't want you around my kid. If we don't have mature vibes, even if we are not friends, I want to still be able to be like, hey, you know, I'm dropping him off to you. You got kids, they playing with each other with that. I want it to be mature. We don't have to be the best of friends. If we do, okay, cool. But all in all, my right. sole purpose, if I'm not messing with him anymore, would strictly be how you're treating my kid. Whatever right. karma she put you through is on you, baby. That ain't got shit to do with me. Yeah. I'm not that invested. Because,
like, when you think about the inner workings of a relationship, like, we need, like, again, we don't got to be best friends. But on some level, we gotta jam. Because there's going to come time in life where I might got to be the third party.
Facts.
Like, I might got to be the nigga that bridged the gap. Like, okay, well, she got stuck at work, so I got a little man.
Right.
And, you know, either I'm going to bring him to you or you can come get him, but you know he's safe.
Super realistic.
Right, like, so you know he's good. Yes. You know what I'm saying? When we get, I bring him to you. All right, bro, you know, we did this, we did that. I've got him McDonald's, you know what I'm saying? So you might not got to feed him for a few hours because he cool right now. And then y'all go do father, son, whatever the fuck it is y'all do.
That's true. I mean, the person who keeping my child should want a relationship with me. They should want to be able to call me. Hey, something's going on with Osiah. Hey, Osiah might have had an asthma attack. It could be any fucking thing. If you can't get to him, I need you to feel comfortable enough to call me. You don't got to be my fucking friend. Right. We don't have to like each other. But I need you to at least have the respect for me that I'm going to have for you. Call me.
People weird.
For sure.
People are,
but that's because people
weird.
Still be fucking. I'm still on that.
And
people still be fucking. Everybody try to act like in this generation fucking is just so. Oh, it's nothing. Just wear a condom, but like so many soul ties, so many emotional connections, and all them demons you carrying with you. That shit is real. I believe in that shit 110%.
And if your son creased my shoes, I'm gonna fuck him up. I ain't gonna lie to you. No,
you
fuck
cannot
that.
Be beating the kid.
Why would he do that to my shoes?
I want him to be like, hee.
Yeah, don't do that. No,
he can't get on his toes.
I will punch the shit out your child. Like, don't hit my baby with your kid.
That's another thing.
Do you got $500? Because to rebuy this shoe is going to cost me $500.
No, he going to be working it off at the summer camp.
He going to be sweating his ass off cutting the grass.
Okay.
And I'm paying him 20 cents on the hour.
Labor.
Yeah, because you fucked up my shoes. I'm going to show you what hard work is like, nigga.
Swing on you, dog.
Yep.
If you
hand that nigga 20 cents.
No, it's 20 cents an hour. So how many hours did you work?
You hand a nigga after 4 hours of yard work on a hot deck, nigga, I'm going to hold you so he can whoop your ass.
Tom, did you fuck up the shoes or did he fuck up the
like,
shoes?
Like, damn.
It's the respect. Bro,
now, if you want to be a great uncle and slide little folks $500 so Juan can rehab his shoes, by all means.
But if not... You're not going to give this nigga no 25 cents an hour.
25 cents an hour. Do you want him to come work at Tone Deaf Studios?
I'll have him come work.
Do you want to pay this little nigga?
Better than working with you, you fucking Nazi.
Because 25 cents an hour. Do you know how long you're going to be working to replace my shoes?
That nigga can make more money in jail. Pressing license plates.
Do you want to go to jail? Because what you did...
With you, he's going to be doing life because he's going to murder you.
Because what you did was a crime.
What you did,
and you will be treated as such with swift justice.
Jail for,
you hear that sound effect?
You're gonna be in jail for broken child labor.
That is how you're gonna be treated if you fuck with my tennis shoes. Swift justice. Swift justice. Yeah, you know what I'm saying? Why washing dishes for a quarter? And I think you're valid. You know?
I think you could definitely do like $5.
Thank you.
No.
My babies make
like $5.
My babies make more.
5 cents?
$5.
Why you ain't got no kids?
He fucked up the shoes. Why I gotta overpay this nigga?
Nigga, that's not over. Minimum wage is $8.
I think we are missing the point of the punishment.
You are missing
the point. I want you to work as hard as I had to work.
It hasn't even happened yet. And we
You didn't work that hard.
I want you to work as hard as I had to work to go to work to get these shoes.
Wow.
Then I had to watch an hour live feed so I could know that they was going to do the early drop. I had to work. It's a blood, sweat, and tears for these tears. All these years to hit these tears. You gonna learn today about Stevie. I bet he won't fuck up another pair of shoes.
I bet he won't.
Yeah,
right, just to fix.
And if he do it just off spite, we gonna fight. We gonna fight then.
Just to fix you up.
You gonna be in jail.
Hit him with a couple body shots.
And then all his shoes is yours.
Hit him with some body shots.
He's setting you up for failure, Juan.
Who?
Because you gave him 25 cents an hour.
He really gonna be on your ass. This nigga got me working and doing this. I mean,
oh, he definitely gonna tell his dad.
He's definitely gonna tell his dad.
Bring your daddy.
He be having me acting like Cinderella.
Bring your punk ass daddy.
And you know what's so funny? Here's the fucked up part. You gonna be like, man, little kid, and you gonna say it to Mimi. And Mimi gonna be like, that's what you get. Stop being cheap, nigga. This is all them years of you not tipping. Mimi gonna do a callback on your ass. You gonna be fucked up.
I be tipping now.
I'm just saying, my nigga.
I ain't tipped back then.
Not back then.
Back then was like last weekend.
Facts.
Sick.
You ever feel like you've done a lot in a short time span?
Like how long we be going through these, how quickly we going through these pods?
Yeah, like not that, but you know, I mean, but when you just have a good conversation, so you can be here all day. Dude. I heard Sheen is finna be in a Rico.
They ain't did shit to me.
Like, why they doing this to the Sheen people?
I can see that, bro. You're not finna sit here and tell me that there's not some kind of washing of the money going on behind the scenes. Cause one, these clothes be cheap as fuck.
Okay.
And the material be cheap as fuck in a lot of these cases too.
I don't know, man. Them Sheen outfits be looking kind of righteous. You don't trust it?
How you gonna trust it when they don't even have our size 97% of the time?
I don't know no man shopping on Shein.
Occasionally, I might go look for a shirt because it looks nice.
Some gems.
But they for the
dudes?
Okay. They ain't made for us.
I know they got some shit on Fashion Nova that niggas, you know,
yeah,
like.
Yeah, because you got a line for us now.
Oh, no. Fashion Nova, man, I fuck with it. I'm going to see what they got.
Some draws and some socks.
And some draws.
Pretty much.
That's all they care about. That's all they think. That's all women places think about us.
I mean, I've seen, like, it's this dude I follow on Instagram. He be wearing, like, the outfits.
They be nice.
Yeah, like he a shoe nigga, and then like he'll model like the outfit and a pair of shoes. I don't know. You know, everybody think they a fucking fashionista and shit. Like,
yeah,
like bro, just fucking. What are you doing, sassy, bro? Just put the fucking god. What are you doing, fam? Like nobody.
Can you date a man?
Nobody cares.
Who dressed better than you?
Damn.
Yeah, he just gonna make me step my swag up a little bit, but it's still gonna make me be like, damn, you care too much. I can't say that because, like, I be putting that shit on too, so it's like,
but you will.
I'm a bad bitch. I'm a bad bitch. I want not manly to look great, and I want him to look great standing beside me.
Is it not period manly to put that shit on?
No,
it is.
The way this world goes, nothing's manly. You can't have no kind of self-care. You're supposed to be an ashy-ass nigga all your life.
No. I actually love a man who take care of himself. I love the fact that, you know, I'll see a man with his nails done, clear coat, toes done, clear coat. Shit like that to me that don't entitle me feeling like, oh, you're gay. Like, that's
gay,
great to me.
I'm not clear coating my nails.
Hey, if you get a mani-pedi, fam, do you. Whatever makes you happy.
I
love me a good clear coat.
You want a facial, my dog? Whatever makes you happy.
Everybody should get facials because niggas definitely have skin issues.
Yes.
Especially now that niggas want to grow their beards and shit. They definitely need to get that shit together.
Yeah, because what be up under niggas' beards, I'd be afraid.
That's why some niggas can't never shave it off.
I'd be like, that shit look like ill.
But it is a regimen that you have to do. And a lot of niggas, they ain't focused.
What's your ideal nigga? Like, if you could build a nigga, what? Like, build a bear, so to speak.
Build a nigga. My nigga would be.
Please be realistic, too.
Realistic.
Don't be like, he'd be 7'9".
Really want a nigga that tall?
To be honest, I can't even say. I want to build a nigga because that's too perfect. That's too perfect.
You want broken niggas.
I don't want broken niggas, but I don't want perfect. I do not want every fucking day to be like whatever you want, my love.
But you know.
I don't want a fucking.
You know
push-over.
The ideal nigga that you want.
The ideal nigga is like a nigga that would literally not do no shit behind my back. Obviously, everybody want the realistic world. We all just don't want a cheater. We all just want somebody that's gonna love us enough to not cheat on us.
Fucking fair as fuck.
Not fuck off.
I don't want you to be super ugly either.
I don't want you to be fucking perfect. I just don't want you to cheat on me.
But here's the irony behind it. That's
You date ugly niggas too?
That's a very basic requirement. I feel like everybody like literally.
What's ugly though?
But the ugly niggas, once you start dating them and you a bad bitch, they always get a little big headed.
Ugly niggas?
Some of them. Some of them.
I don't date bad bitches.
Why can't they have a little
big headed in a way where like chill? Like, I don't know.
Like, what's big headed?
Big headed, like now you feel like you can go off and fuck around on me, or you because feel like the way you used to talk to me, now you talking different. It's becoming a little assholy, or it's like,
well, that's
you be having humble. Love don't cross the thing vibe.
That's exactly they learn, what I mean. They're learning how to be. It's not new to them.
Okay.
Like when you've been an ugly nigga or be considered ugly in a lot of eyes, or you tried to shoot your shot at some girls and they shot you down and talked about you, your confidence level is pretty low.
Mm-hmm.
So when you get a chick who builds up your confidence level and she a baddie on top of that, so when you out in public, you got all the niggas who want to fuck your bitch, you get a little cocky. It's naturally going to happen. But they have to learn how to control how that energy is conveyed. So they don't want to come off. They're not purposely trying to come off. Most of them are not purposely trying to come off as assholes. They're just trying to come off a little bit more confident. So when they're talking to you, you
can like, hey, get that
voice, get that bass out your voice. It's like, nigga, you the reason why I got bass now.
Not even necessarily get that bass out your voice, because like I'm not trying to be your mama. I'm very much so just trying to be your woman. But you know, still respect me as such. Yes, you got better clothes, better confidence, or whatever the case may be, but...
Them the niggas who didn't get no pussy.
Yes. Still treat me as fucking such. Yeah, still treat me with respect.
They didn't
been live all this time?
Huh? Oh. No.
They didn't get no pussy in life.
No.
And then when they met a pretty bitch to give them some...
It's
went,
like, oh yeah.
Went crazy.
You're done.
Went crazy.
Of course you're gonna go crazy.
Have an attack.
Went crazy.
I mean, because now you bagged the Keke Palmer. You got the Angela Bassett or
I just hate when niggas say, well, you're so fine. Why are you single? Why the fuck do you think
that's because niggas be niggas?
Why the fuck do you think I'm single? Because I got a brain, because I'm not going for no bullshit, because I'm not allowing you to cheat. I'm not allowing you to come home at 6 o'clock in the fucking morning. Okay, cool. If you at work, cool.
But then they really don't want a bad bitch.
If you a street nigga, cool. But it has to be a reason why you're doing this. If you think you just out at the club with your niggas,
that's gay.
You coming in at 5-6, that's too much for me. You was with a bitch.
Well, see,
you
was with some niggas at 5 a.m, my guy.
You was with a bitch.
Counting money and breaking these bricks.
You was with a bitch.
There was bitches there.
Somebody got to break.
We weren't
but
just,
some bitches was
we
there.
Wasn't just
or your
there.
Nigga had some type of two man going on. We is not acting crazy here. These niggas don't, they be knowing what
why
they be
you,
doing.
You know too much.
I do.
Get out of our business.
I do, because it be two man games. Oh, he whole time it probably don't even be my nigga who bringing the bitch around.
Of course.
He just gotta be the friend of the friend and the ugly ass girl that's there like.
Yeah, I get sometimes, in trouble trying to be the nigga to get my nigga out of
right,
trouble.
Like exactly. Sometimes we wingman for our guy like. Juan could be meeting the bad bitch, and then she got a friend.
But
like,
I swear to God.
In order for Juan to get closer to her, somebody got to occupy the friend. So I might have to be there to occupy the friend. And all of a sudden, the friend was like, well, I'm bored. And all of a sudden, zip. Hey.
Yeah, bro. See, you got to take. Yeah,
I got to take one for the team.
I fuck some ugly bitches for my homeboys. I ain't going to lie to you.
I would never put you in that position.
I was young though. Like,
I would never put you in that position.
Hey, man,
I'm not talking to the friend of the friend. I'll sit there
sometimes
and literally have conversation with you.
The friend of the friend is just a better choice.
I will have conversation with you just because we're out here and they up in the room. We do not gotta fuck. Roll up.
Well, no, I mean that's upon me.
Let's talk about the stars and the moon.
Again, this is when I was younger.
Yeah.
So when you younger, the game was way different back then.
It wasn't a game. It was like, hey, you down?
Right. It was like
you're not gonna
most girls like they didn't want to be left out. So if you know your friend upstairs fucking, you gonna try to get you some. Especially if you think I'm cute to a degree.
Man, it was wildest line I have ever used that actually worked. Guy upstairs. Bagging his chick, I'm downstairs. Her friend down there, she looking bored. We have a regular conversation because you know I'm a conversational kind of a dude.
I feel
okay. So you know you hear headboards moving. I was like, damn, they having a great time. This old girl said, man, they are. I'm ready to go home. I just like, I got a big dick, though. And, oh, you do? Shit happened.
That's
the wildest line I've ever
used.
I got a big dick, though.
Pause, so, man.
Yeah. It worked. Ready.
Oh, God. Too much.
Said is the wildest line I've ever used, and it worked.
Town.
What up, though?
That's some nigga shit.
That's crazy.
I was a young nigga.
Hey, but
there was a point in time in my see you're new to me.
It'd be like that though. Okay?
And what you will find out over time is in my early 20s,
Tone was a whore.
Wild lifestyle.
He was a whore.
Very, very wild lifestyle.
He was playing Russian roulette with his dick, just throwing his dick on a crap table. Oh, many a night. Many a night.
I say I won because I walked out with no diseases and no
kids. Oh, for sure. I didn't say you lost. You definitely didn't crap out.
No diseases and no kids.
Facts.
I got to give it to you. Look at that.
Right. I bet on black.
You should. That's the name of this episode. I bet on black.
So I came out pretty good, but I got some stories to prove it. But, and these niggas will have no problem bringing them up.
Oh, for sure.
Never.
He was in the Air Force. Ooh. See, enough said. I didn't even have to go into detail.
It was the eyes for me, bro.
You like a military man?
I don't know.
She likes stability.
You got your uniform in the closet?
Bruh, not that one.
TBH, I prefer consistency over stability. That sound bad.
Don't talk to me in text message either.
Explain.
Okay.
Consistency.
So
if I'm a everyday fuck nigga, but I come home and love you for who you are. All my dirt stay out that door. So the minute I walk in that door, you're the only thing I care about. But if I do that consistently, you'll choose that over stability.
Because stability being to me, I think the word stability is probably going over my head. But stability to me is like financials. Are you taking care of me? Are you taking care of home? Are you making sure that
she I'm saying safe? She got that, bro. So many
yeah.
words.
I get where you're coming from. You don't need his money because you got your own. But that's
not even nope, not even necessarily the money either, but more so along the lines of stability don't outweigh, you know what I'm saying, you constantly loving me, you constantly being there for me, you constantly treating me how you treated me to get me, or
because I can make sure you well taken care of and still fuck off.
Yeah,
but I think where a lot of people make the mistake at is you need both simultaneously. You can't choose one over the other. See, because I can love you for you and I can always make you feel appreciated. I can always make you feel happy. But in the back of your mind, you don't know how rent getting paid next month. And that's going to deter you how you look at me. Or if you got to work toward extra hours to make sure money's in the house, even though you have a go-getter mentality, you're going to be asking yourself, why am I giving 80 and you're giving 20?
Mm-hmm.
So that stability or the ability to be able to not have to worry about where the next meal is coming from, when the bills are being paid, money in the savings account, no car note that has to be worked. If all the financial side of things is completely taken care of, or even better, on auto pay, that's how good y'all got it, it's easier for me to focus on you and you to focus on me because we're not putting any extra work in to make sure we have a roof over our head or food in our mouth. Now we can focus on each other. And usually when those problems are out the way, I don't have a need to be out here in the streets because I'm not stressing over this bill and because you're not stressing me. I'm not out at this bar drinking, trying to get my woes away. Who now this bitch over there is like, hey, you look good. You want to have a good time? And I go home with her and stay for that night because I'm tired of you stressing on me.
But to be honest, one thing plays into another, which is why I said I'll take that over there, because if you're being consistent, that comes with stability. That comes with, you know what I'm saying, you being able to build a foundation or, you know, build off solitude. Like I'm a full firm believer in, if I'm coming home, I'm consistently loving you, I'm consistently doing right, I'm consistently going to work, doing what I got to do, or I'm consistently putting in work in whatever it is that I'm an entrepreneur in, or it's that all that is going to bring stability. All of that is going to bring more love. All of that is going to bring a bond that it's just so really unbreakable.
You can have consistency. You have consistency and stability, but you can also just have stability, no consistency.
No, that's true. And that's where it come into play. Because
I can make sure you good. You can make sure
I'm straight and literally not have no touch or spark on my mind mentally or emotionally.
Right. And that's what it was great. I'm not trying to be funny, but there's a lot of girls in your age category. That's what they want. They want a nigga to do all of that for them to keep them stable and could care less about him. Because they still strung up on the baby daddy that's in jail.
See, I'm more so looking at it in a mindset of...
Hey, if I meet you and you tell me that your baby daddy in jail, I'm not talking to you.
No, why? I don't know.
He's not here.
Hold on. I got to ask how long he in when he get out.
I don't care.
No, because that can make a difference of whether it's a good time
family work or a long time.
Because if he's getting out in less than 2 years, then let's just have some fun right now.
All we can do is, once you say, I have a baby daddy and he's in jail, all we can do is fuck after that.
Why?
Because what if she just have a baby daddy? She's not waiting for him.
That's not my problem.
The key word is baby daddy. She didn't say, well, my boyfriend's in jail.
That's not my problem. You figure that out. I've told you where I stand.
She checks all 10 boxes.
I've told you where I stand.
She checks all 10 boxes.
That's a problem I just rather not have.
Why is it a problem?
Because
he's in jail. That's better than him being out.
He lurking in the shadows.
How?
But he's behind bars.
Okay.
You would rather talk to
what
him.
What if this is the nigga who's running up the fucking phone bill? What if I ask you where your money going and I find out you putting money on his books? That's still shit.
That's different.
All right then. So even if it ain't there,
you don't want me to put money on these books so you can talk to his kid?
Yeah, it's all for the kids.
You in jail. Where's his mama?
Maybe she dead, bro. You 35 years old, bro. Everybody mama ain't still alive.
Where your family at, bro?
He talks to them too.
Okay.
But you putting money on the books or buying the phone card.
You see how y'all adding these variables to a situation. In the beginning, I said no to.
Because we're looking at the no. Your no is absolute.
Absolutely.
Without having context.
And I don't
behind
need context.
The fact of.
Do you know that there are 24 hours in a day, right?
Let me ask you this question.
It's 24 hours in a day, right?
1,440 minutes.
Do you know how much shit people just say no to without context within 24 hours in a day?
But here's my thing.
Juan. I just want to know why is that your deal breaker.
Some shit you just don't need context.
Here's my thing, Juan. The reason why a lot of us, when you say no to stuff and we hit you with what you refer to as variable, because we want you to look at the coin if you were in that same position. You got into a situation that you're now in jail for 2 years.
Okay.
And your girlfriend with your child is on the outside. Even though you're not going to be home in 2 years, you want her to still continue to at least be that point of contact for you while you're behind bars, right?
Right.
You got a mama, you got a sister, you got brothers. And even though they still communicate with you, she got your kid, though. Don't you still want to have communication with your kid, though?
I get what you're saying.
As long as that's the only form of communication.
The baby mama and the baby daddy, whatever they got going on, that's them. I'm telling you that I do not want any part of that because I am not mature enough to deal with it. So when I say no, I'm not doing things is because I understand that my level of maturity on certain topics ain't where it should be to deal with that.
But Juan, we're riding right now, so you got to put that part out there too.
Oh, I'm just saying, you watch the internet a little bit, right? Do you know what Adam 22 is?
No.
Adam 22 is a famous podcaster. And on the side of doing podcasting, his wife is an OnlyFans star. So they fuck on OnlyFans and get profit. Now, they have only did scenes with other women, or it's just them. Or she lets him fuck other girls. Now, recently, he stepped outside of his comfort zone and was like, I'm going to let my wife do a scene with another guy. Now, granted, you let her fuck a dick probably way bigger than yours, pause, but hey, whatever floats your boat is cool. I am not here to judge whatever it is that they got going on in their relationship. I am here to tell you that Dwan, Dinkins, the Pie Guy, Young Fresh, whatever motherfuckers know me by, I am not mature enough to be like, hey, babe, let's fuck up. Nah, I'm not mature enough to do it.
Him,
but that's on any level.
No. since we here, because we were supposed to talk about this story anyway. Him, and then we're gonna close it out. He's a bitch ass nigga.
Damn.
And here's the reason why I say that. When it was your wife, girlfriend, or whatever she is, and you were bringing in other women, and she stepped back, was like, okay, you can fuck these women. Your feelings is good. You cool. You okay. Your dick is dicking down multiple different women, and you are phenomenal. But now the shoe is on the other foot, and it's your woman who's the actual star of this story here now, okay? Right. I want you to know that niggas didn't subscribe to the OnlyFans for him. They subscribed for her. She now go out and get a dick, and it's like, oh my God, I can't believe that. Oh, this is too much to handle.
Going back, right?
How do you know that she didn't feel the same way? And the problem with that was, it wasn't the fact you felt that way. That's not the reason why you a bitch ass nigga. You a bitch ass nigga because you ran to the internet about it. You wanted sympathy from other niggas, but you put her in this position, and you allow yourself.
No, I mean,
facts,
he wasn't not okay with it. He was all for it. Like, he was cool with it. I had the issue with the fact of, like, if I know that my dick is a solid 6 inches, and you are cool with this 6-inch pipe that I'm slinging. Right, you know what I'm saying? And but then you be like, well, let's do it. Let me try another guy. And I'm like, okay, cool. And then you go get the nigga who got me by like a solid 7 inches. That's wild as fuck, bro.
But
like, if you gonna go
business.
If you gonna go get a dick that look like mine.
No, nope,
don't go get a nigga who just dropping baby arms on the motherfucking coffee table.
Okay.
That's wild as shit.
Since we here now. No, hold on. Since we here, and I was getting ready to get there. Since we here now, and we're secure in our sexuality.
I'm not mature enough.
If you gonna go from a white dude to a black dude, let's just go ahead and go full blown stereo type. Yeah. So let's just get. Well, I'm gonna get a black dude. I'm gonna get a big dick black dude because this is what they known for.
She
so if we gonna do it, let's just do it right.
She went and got Hulk Hogan arm out this bitch.
I'm just saying, and she took it like a champ.
That's crazy.
The whole video leaked. The video leaked. So. Yeah,
and he let her give him the sloppy toppy. Like, you not like fucking is one thing. This you can't suck his
sloppy toppy. That's intimate.
You can't suck his dick, Jim.
Hold on, now we taking it too motherfucking far.
But you are an OnlyFans.
Business is business, but you can't suck his dick.
No, but that's business.
That's not business.
Yes, look, bro. One
sucking dick ain't business.
That is why you can't date a chick who's either a porn star. Or an OnlyFans, because from what I heard, those are two different
sucking
things.
Dick ain't business.
It's business, Juan.
No, not
it's
in my world.
You want to know how it's business? Because it's the first thing that happens in every scene.
Now, that's
and
getting,
sometimes
that's
it's
getting,
the only scene.
That's getting to the business.
It's business, Juan.
But it ain't business.
Business, Juan. At the end of the day.
Would you let your man fuck somebody else?
No.
Let alone eat the pussy.
I can't even. As much as my curiosity be like, ooh, threesomes. I can't even do it because I'm just crazy. Like, I see you just drilling and just fucking too good. And then it's like, bop, you getting cut in the back of your head. You don't even know why.
You can't punch people in the middle of a threesome.
Yes, I can.
You can't fight while everybody's naked.
Yes, I can.
You just going to have a vagina out and just start slapping.
That's how it's going to sound. That's dick slanging, titty slanging.
Are you into girls?
I plead the fifth.
This is a safe space, so we already know.
Right?
No, because she brung up threesomes, and it's like a lot of times women will agree to do a threesome for their man, but don't be into women. They're just doing it for him. So the question of are you into girls was like to even be curious about doing a threesome. Do you want a man, woman, or?
Oh, That's a tricky situation.
I would definitely.
One, how many times we said no kink shaming? Because
I just said it was a tricky situation.
It's
I just feel like
that's frowned upon.
Two men?
Yes.
And a woman?
Yes. If that's what she wants, yes, it is.
Who frowns upon
you?
Them?
Just literally. No, that's a tricky situation. You literally gave it a negative connotation. Just gave it a negative connotation.
Because I can't take nothing serious, bro. I don't frown upon it. If you want to fuck two niggas at the same time, get your shit off.
And you see what? And
I feel
can't handle that.
I feel like
women to be okay with bringing another woman into the equation, and they think that the loophole is if I let her pick the woman.
That's because niggas not mature.
I can't.
And again, I'm not mature enough to where my girl can sit down and be like, "Hey, man, let's go get another nigga." Absolutely not. But because I know I'm not mature enough for that, I'm not putting threesomes on the table just in case you try to hit me with some shit like that. Because
when I got asked, I actually got asked, like, you know, would you have a threesome and, you know, the correlation.
They're not wrong.
And I'm like, oh, okay. So I could fuck two dudes too? We could all have one. And he's like, bro, I'm not finna fucking
do you really wanna fuck
out and have another nigga with his dick out.
But do
that's
you?
That's just taking it too fucking far.
Do you really want to fuck two dudes?
No.
Or then why would you say that?
I just feel like I wanted him to know the correlation of.
If you go, don't ask.
That's
me.
Extreme, bro. You could have just said.
Don't ask me to go ask. Don't ask me would I fuck a bitch if we can't fuck a nigga.
What if he'd be like, yeah, let's do it?
That would have been kind of awkward.
But
I don't know. Either way, it's weird. So I'm supposed to like take two dicks at one time. Like, I don't know. The whole thing is weird.
If you're in a double penetration, that's it.
That's weird.
That's a category on my favorite app.
But I'm just saying, like, so, okay.
You said what?
Some women be up for the challenge.
He fuck it. And then, like, when I'm done with him, I got to fuck him.
It don't even have to be that. It could be simultaneously.
Just, right. And he could be, and he could, one could be hitting it from the back. You could be sucking dick. We could be high-fiving. We out here.
Or it can be a party where one the pink and one the stink. It depends on how you get there.
Now,
the dicks are too close.
That's
at that
a little
point.
Too close.
The dicks are too close at that point.
I'm not saying. I'm just saying it's a lot of shit that's too close.
Now,
if I'm up top, you down low, or I'm down low, you up top, we good. We Montana and Florida. That's cool. But we cannot be like Texas and Alabama.
Texas and Alabama is
crazy. Nah, Louisiana and fucking Alabama.
It would
nah.
be more like Oklahoma and Texas.
That's still crazy.
It'd be more like Northern South Carolina.
That's close as fuck, though.
That's
but
Madison.
I'm just saying, some people. I don't want
your thigh on my
thigh, bro. Yeah, no. It's all about positioning.
But it's different when you are a woman and you are actually interested in women and you are actually someone who has had a relationship with a woman. Then, yes, the pleasure is yours. You are getting that pleasure out of the woman more
Have
so.
Have you had a relationship with the woman?
What? No. Well, yes. But it was like a long time ago.
Like what if we kind of like getting to it and like you on like the downstroke and you like work up a sweat and like you hit a stroke and now your sweat fling on me, bam. I gotta stop.
Okay.
You have to stop.
If you north of South Carolina, right? So if you Carolina, technically she's in between y'all like an Oreo cookie. So you really should physically, if you position yourself right, y'all should honestly never touch each other.
If you position yourself right, that's a lot of fucking work.
And it also depends on how much balls you got. Because if your balls ain't too low, I
done seen some big balls.
So, but at the same time, you got to be secure in your manhood that sometimes those certain things.
Listen,
like that
security
bother.
Only gonna go.
No, I'm saying. No, real talk. There's sometimes that's not even
big
thought
balls, man.
Like you here for
that's
you wore that. I just want you to know that. You have so many complications.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to thank everybody for coming out and hanging out with Def Fresh and Diamond. And something else is hanging out with us too, apparently. But you know, it's all good. You know what I'm saying? It's all to the good. It's all to the good. I appreciate everybody for rocking with the homeboy. See y'all later, man. Until next time.